It's in my liquor cabinet right here. Let's go over them. I mean, I have all of mine presented for you. So where do I begin? Okay, let me just take it maybe this side and we'll just kind of slowly make our way over here, okay? So first of all, we've got this gin, Hardshore Gin, which is very cool. We've got some kind of interesting liquors that from our liquor store. I have this Elise, what is this, the blue?
That's the blue passion we use for...
Yeah. The blue passion.
I'm just gonna go to my liquor cabinet and show everybody.
Right. I've got Lillet. I've got, I believe this is the dry vermouth, or the blanc vermouth that you left here.
Yes.
I've got Grenadine right here. We've got Contreau, just a little bit of Contreau. We've got this excellent straight bourbon whiskey. This is made in Indiana, distilled in Indiana. And it's really good stuff from my liquor store. This sweet vermouth right here. Sweet vermouth, the red vermouth. Bitters, we're rocking a bunch of stuff, okay? For bitters, we've got Regan's orange bitters, of course. Can't live without it. We've got these Worcestershire sauce. This is for the Bloody Mary I'm going to start tonight out with. Then we have these black walnut bitters right there. Lexi picked those up. Lexi also picked up this assortment of various different bitters. This little box that says, how many bitters are in here? Four different types of bitters. We'll break into that later. We also have these citrus bitters. We do love our bitters in this household. Also, you can't go without the Tabasco sauce. Then we've got some pickles right there. Then, oh my God, did I mention these? No, these are the Angostura bitters. Oh my God, how many bitters? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 different bitters. We have a problem, Lex.
I've got at least that many myself. It would actually take too long, I think, to go through the contents of my liquor cabinet.
So this is the entirety of my liquor cabinet. If you want to give us a brief description of what your liquor cabinet is,
Me or Chat? What are you talking about?
You brought us over to your liquor cabinet, but
should I go over it again?
Did you already go over it?
I did. Well, you know, I just kind of did it while you were talking. I'll do it again real quick. I've got some of my stuff over here, but I'm going to walk this over. All right. Here, we got our vermouths. Wow.
Yep.
And stuff. We've got like Elise. If you go back further, there's like some pins and stuff.
Oh, I also have the hearing. I have the hearing cherry liqueur, rather. As
got
well,
my, my tequila over here. I've got some Calvados and some other stuff. And got some like some cognac and stuff in the center thing. Then I've got like I normally have my rye right here. Here's some Russell's Reserve, some bourbon.
A disgusting giant bottle of Smirnoff vodka. Nice.
Yeah, in case you need it. Bloody Marys and whatnot. So.
Right. I should also mention, speaking of Bloody Marys, I also do have this. Tomato juice or whatever it is for the Bloody Mary that I'm about to make.
And then over here is like my bitters and stuff. So I've got Hellfire bitters, I got Chocolate Rose, I've got Celery bitters, I've got Mr. Pimento bitters.
So you're rocking crazy bitters too.
Yeah.
All right. Also, I see Nightbot has posted the.
I'm kissing Lindsay right now.
No.
Nightbot also has posted the incentives, so I might as well read them out. Cocktail incentives: $5 for a toast or roast to you, $10 to choose one of us to perform karaoke, $25 for a lip sync competition with Jeff and Holden. You name the song, you can donate here. There you go. Holden, you're a free-to-play in an MMO compared to Jeff's level 99 amount of alcohol. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I'm rocking. I've got so the liquors, we've got vodka, gin, and bourbon. I think those are the only three liquors.
You got all the essentials.
I've got all the essentials. I don't have tequila, but good. I'm glad. Yo, what's up, Zombie Apocalypse? What's up, Square Knot? I hate everybody. So shut up, Joe Holio. DocsX Dank, what's up? Thank you for the cocktail emotes, by the way. Blasting those, Swish Pod. Jess Nope. Soat. Koala. Kamikaze Mixtape. Dude, welcome everybody to the stream. Walter B. Quaid, welcome everybody to the stream. And yeah, let us begin. I'm starting off with Bloody Mary. So let me, so the step number one is I'm doing two parts vodka for my Bloody Mary. We've got the Tito's right here.
And I'm doing the, Sherlock. So I'm doing, it goes two parts bullet rye.
It's got my
specifically hazy bullet rye.
Wait, which one are you doing?
I don't know. I'm considering, should I make a double?
I mean, that's entirely up to you, honestly. Oh, whoops, I'm not
doing
this.
No, we'll be cautious to start off with, actually.
There's so much stuff on the table, I don't know what to do with myself right now. Here we go, and then this is shot two.
Double? All right. Okay, Lindsay said double from the bathroom where she is giving our daughters a bath.
So. Numero dos on the steps is... hi, Lindsay. Is blank parts blank. So for that, I mean, I don't know if I'm even going to measure this out. Well, no, maybe I will. Maybe what do you think? How many parts of tomato juice did I do if I did two shots of tequila?
I always kind of eyeball it. I do.
Same.
Yeah.
But if you were a guessing man, would you say four parts?
Yeah. I'm now moving on to part two of the Sherlock, which is one quarter part cherry hearing. So since I've done four shots in there, I'm going to go ahead. Wait.
I did four parts of the tomato
part.
Juice.
I said a half part cherry hearing. So, but I'm going to do one full shot since I've done a double here.
All right, I'll wait for you to catch up, and then we'll do part three. Two? You think two? I think four. I'm drinking a War Pigs Foggy Geezer Hazy IPA. That sounds delicious. I miss my fancy craft IPAs. I don't really know if my fancy craft place is open. I haven't been over by there, but I'm going to have to check at some point. Yo, what's up, something, I guess? All right, are we on to step three?
Yep.
Step three is add blank and or blank. So in my case, I'm adding Worcestershire sauce, and
I'm doing a shot of Lillet Blanc.
Just added some driblets of Worcestershire sauce.
All of these are in the this drink at least is in the cocktails archives if you want the proper instructions.
A little bit of hot sauce in there, and a little more.
A little bit of orange bitters.
All right. Step four, shake, stir with ice and pour. So there you go. Let's stir this puppy up.
This is a shaker.
I believe a bloody gets stirred. I don't think I would. Using my bar key, by the way. My trusty bar key that Lexi got me. That's the same as yours. Holding the hair and beard are looking sharp AF. Thank you so much. Well, I got that. I got a haircut from Lexi on stream last Friday during Jackanese, and I think it went quite well. She's still like, oh, this is wrong with it and that's wrong with it. But I think for the most part, she did a great job. We had to give the beard a second little touch up. Yeah, we are mixing drinks, making drinks. This is Cocktails, the stream. This, due to the coronavirus, the enjoy your blank. So in my case, by the way, I'm also going to throw some pepper in here as well. It's a bloody, got to have that. And I'm going to add a couple of pickles to my drink. Oh, whoops, we're off the screen. Okay, so let me add a couple pickles.
Zombie Apocalypse 1980 said, I wish I wasn't scared of heading to the liquor store now. I think I'll have a Bacardi and Coke, an additional shot of Makers. I don't know if where you live they have this or something like it. There's this app that I have called Minibar, and I use that to get my liquor now. You actually just put an order in, and they'll just come and deliver liquor to your house, as long as there's somebody, you know, over 21 to
to accept the liquor, then they're good. But yeah, they'll just leave it on the porch for you. And yeah, I don't know if there's other apps like that, but yeah, it's called Mini Bar, and so, it's a good way to get liquor brought to your house.
So for me, my liquor store actually has its own app. And,
oh, really?
Yeah, let's, by the way, cheers, Jeff.
Cheers.
On another quarantine edition of cocktails. Mmm. Very different drinks. Me with my Bloody Mary. You with your Sherlock. And so let's go over that again. Tonight's drink is the dealer's choice. We are using the available contents of our liquor cabinet. If you're new to the stream, we normally do a very specific drink and show you how to make it. But in these trying times, we're trying something a little different. Step one is blank parts blank. I'm making a Bloody Mary, so I added 2 parts vodka. Jeff, you're making a Sherlock, so you added?
I added, I made a double, it would be 2 parts bullet rye.
Step two, blank parts blank. I did 4 parts Bloody Mary, and I know that's usually a little different, usually you just kind of eye it, but I decided I would try to do it, you know, through shots. And I really do think it's 2-1. I did 4 shots of the Bloody Mary mix on top of the 2 shots of vodka. I think this is a perfect mix.
Yeah.
Step 3, add blank and or blank. I added Worcestershire sauce. Oh, wait, I'm sorry. I skipped you. What did you, how many parts of what for step 2?
A half a part of cherry herring for part 2.
Fantastic. Now we move on to step 3, add blank and or blank. I added Worcestershire sauce, Tabasco, pepper, and I put pickles in the glass. What do you got going?
I got another half part of Lillet, and then I did a couple drops of Reagan's orange bitters.
Fantastic. And then lastly, step 4, shake/stir with ice and pour, and enjoy your, in my case, Bloody Mary. And in Jeff's case, Sherlock. That's the dealer's choice. Thank you so much for joining us, everybody, for this edition of the stream. Let's talk about the week. Let's sit back. Let's enjoy some drinks. And let's get into this. What do you think? First of all, why don't I start with this? I feel like I should have added an incentive in order to, and I was trying to, by the way, really quick side note, I was trying to figure out what SquareNut was referencing. Is he actually referencing, he's referencing Space Captain.
Yeah, he was saying praise King Zino. Which I really appreciate.
At first I was like, what the fuck is SquareNut talking about?
that's the character that I play in Space Captain, Captain of Space, streaming now on Amazon Prime.
Check it out. I don't have the promotional image available. I did not prepare. But just go check out Space Captain, Captain of Space on Amazon.
We're getting some really good, not a ton of people have watched it yet, but the people who have watched it, other than just like our parents and us, are seeming to really enjoy it. And we've got a bunch of 5-star reviews so far and some really good reviews coming in. So if anybody really, really feels compelled to help us out, go on Amazon, just, you know, you feel, hey, let's drop a couple 5-star reviews on
please
Captain of Space.
There's the link.
I won't stop you. I won't dissuade you. Only do that if you want to. Obviously, I'm not.
No, definitely do it.
It would definitely help us. But
he's desperate for you to do it. He's gonna lose his fucking daughters if you don't do it. He's got 2.
No, I'm hoping just it'll appear in people's queues and it will get out to more people. But
just do it.
Know, I'm not your fucking dad. All right, I'm not gonna tell you what to do. So.
Yeah, I know you want him to be your dad, dude, which is weird, okay? But he's not. But what he is drinking, and this is the show where we drink. What do we got? What are you guys drinking on since it's the dealer's choice tonight? Beam on the Rocks with Rheingeist Zengo. No problem. You're welcome, TV, for me. Anybody else drinking anything at this point? I know someone else said they were enjoying a delicious hazy IPA. I love a good hazy IPA. Absolutely love them. Does King Zino keep Moet and Chandon in a pretty cabinet? The people want to know.
Wait, what? Where was that? Oh, does King Zino keep Moet and Chandon? He's more of a... Oh, we did Space Champagne, remember, a couple weeks ago.
That was
one of the last ones we did before before all this quarantine happened, actually. A couple episodes of that, we did one called Space Champagne, which I don't remember off the top of my head what it is, but I think that's where that Alizé, that blue passion liqueur came from that you've got over there. It's from Space Champagne, which is a good drink. I'm actually going to post that on Facebook next week, I think.
Nice.
I'm doing little promotionals like every Friday, trying to get more people to
damn, people drinking
watch. Just... So the next one I'll do, I'll promote the Space Champagne as well.
People drinking just straight liquor, straight gin, baby, says TV for me, which is pretty wild. I know that's a good gin you're drinking. I can only drink it straight if it's like really, really good. And Wild Turkey 101 straight, hell yeah. It's also a reference to the Queen song Killer Queen. Very interesting. I love that arcade cabinet. So
yeah, she'd know that. I should text her, let her know we're doing this right now, actually, in case she's not aware.
So tonight I could be making all sorts of things. You know, I may make the Sherlock as well, Jeff. I may do a round of Manhattans. We unfortunately don't have any Salerno right now, so I cannot make the old fashioned. We actually have some on its way via the mail.
Oh shit.
90 proof to kill the COVID, fantastic. Yeah, there's so many different things, and I may ask you to create something for me, Jeff.
To do what?
I may ask you to create something for me, Jeff.
Okay. I can do that.
Would you also be willing for a $100 donation to make a suicide drink where we pour a little bit of everything into a cup and you drink it?
I wouldn't be able to do... every single thing in my liquor cabinet, because there's too much in there. But
maybe you have to mix 10 items in a cup. How about that?
It's like $10 per item.
Yeah, so it's like $10 per item. Secret incentive for $100. We get to choose the ingredients, but yes. We have to put 10 different items into the cup, and we will drink. Holy and we crap. Will take it as a suicide shot, essentially.
Mm-hmm.
Well, just a little bit of everything, all right? And we'll add some rules to that. Like, you're only allowed to do bitters once.
Make my dog drink it as well.
Hell yeah! We only are allowed to do bitters one time for our ingredient. You know what I mean? We'll make a couple rules, all right, to ensure that we don't cheat you out of that $100 shot, suicide shot.
So yeah, I'll even promise to put a little bit of absinthe into mine.
And I'll promise to put a little bit of tomato juice in mine. And I will. And we have to mix at least two liquors.
Yeah.
At least two. We'll figure it out. We'll put the terms. I say two liquors. It has to be at least. No, you know what? It has to be three liquors. It's got to be.
And what? Yeah.
Five liqueurs. And two bitters. How about that?
I like that. Yeah.
I like that.
So I think I could probably make something delicious up there with that.
It's three liquors. That's
going to be hard with three liquors, though. Three.
It's going to be so gross. And I'll definitely put tomato juice in mine. And Jeff will definitely put some absinthe in his. Joe Holio says, can we all contribute to it? I'm going to hold out for one special benefactor to do it. And I will maybe make it a cumulative donation situation in the last like hour. I'm gonna see if anybody wants to be the hero in the first.
But of course, I mean, everybody, you know, it's difficult economic times, so we appreciate that too. So don't go nuts if you know, think about your finances before you do that.
TV for me asks a good question. What would the incentive for actual suicide be? I guess if you gave Lexi.
Yeah,
$20 million, $20 million maybe. That's worth my life. That's my life. And then she'll be good to go. She's a man, baby, with $5 from Zombie Apocalypse. Toast to Logan Xavier. I promise to not bring it up. Fantastic. Logan Xavier?
It's hot in my apartment. I'm going to open my window a little bit.
Excited to see Space Captain. I think my wife and I are going to do an episode. She's a man, baby, from Squared Out with $100. The suicide shot will happen. The suicide shot will happen this evening.
It's
when do we do it? Should we wait till the end? Squared Out, let us know what you think. Should we do it now? Should we do it at the very end? I'm thinking we should do it in the last hour.
It doesn't seem like, yeah.
Oh, what's up, Dorf?
Like start the stream with that.
Wait till later. Yeah, I think we should be a little more lit up.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Also, which ones?
We're not here to see you, buddy. Thank you.
I'm confused by Logan Xavier. Did my message not go through? Yeah, that's weird. Let me pull it up. Yeah, it went through here, but it didn't go through. I promise I won't bring it up again after this. You were great, Holden. Oh, okay. Yeah, it cut off Zombie's message, too. Don't worry, I will read these messages out loud. I say start now and keep taking up until the shower is over. Taking him until the shower is over. Oh, God. Okay. Zombie Apocalypse, a toast to Logan Xavier. I promise not to bring it up again after this. You were great, Holden. And to be 100% sincere, I probably... Oh, Logan Xavier is Zombie Apocalypse's kid that I made fun of his name. Remember? Do you remember that, Jeff? Were you here for that, or was that on a different stream? Logan Xavier is Zombie Apocalypse's name that I made fun of. I said it was a bad...
Maybe it was a different stream.
Maybe it was a different stream. I said it was a bad name.
You might have done it, and it just is a fog for me. So
I said it was a bad name, and then Zombie Apocalypse was like, that's my kid's name. 100% short, sincere. I probably was trying too hard. Sorry, Marvel fanboy, and Wolverine number 42 was my first comic. Fantastic. All right, here's the Squarenauts comment. Also, I am citing Wizbrew's Tarantino episode and Space Captain, Captain of Space in the last paper for my bachelor's. Hail yourselves. Thanks for everything you both do. Thank you so much, Squarenaut.
Squarenaut, you were really supportive of that. I know that you, I've been back on Facebook a little bit here and there for the first time in a couple of years. And I saw, like, you posted out the link to Space Captain. I really appreciate that, man. Thank you.
So it seems like the messages are a little weird tonight on Streamlabs for some reason. I will always check the actual Streamlabs website, and the message should be on there. So, all right. Well, here we go. Let's get into it. Once again, really quick before we do, just start shooting the shit about our week and making more drinks. Here are the incentives for tonight. The secret incentive has been met, so that is off the table now. Cocktails incentives, $5 a toast or roast to you, $10 to choose one of us to perform karaoke. I'd love to get a karaoke block going at the end of the hour if possible. And you name the song, by the way. You name the song. You name the person to sing it. And $25 for a lip sync competition with Jeff and Holden. Again, you name the song. It was $200 for Jeff Starter to drink one, right? Yeah, absolutely. It was $200 for to introduce one of Jeff's daughters to alcohol. That is not true. That is completely I have to actually state that's not true, but that's not true. You can donate right there at the link, just like Squarenaut and Zombie Apocalypse already graciously did. And let's give a toast to Logan Xavier, one of the greatest names on the planet, a boy that is destined to be a special child with mutant abilities that will be sort of held up against normal human society, and it'll be a big metaphor for racism and this whole situation, but hopefully the boy or boy probably will have claws or something, spikes that come out somewhere, and will win the day against Magneto. Hey, thank you again, Zombie Apocalypse. Cheers. Yeah, what do you got for us, Jeff? Zombie Apocalypse's child.
Zombie, what?
Logan Xavier. Zombie Apocalypse's child. Completely normal name, Logan Xavier. I'm drinking of the Truth IPA by Flying Dog. Pretty decent. Very nice, Fat President.
You're weirdly cutting out a little bit with me. I don't know if I'm cutting out over there, too, but...
No, I'm hearing you pretty well. Let me check.
Good.
Zoom decided to just do all these fun new... settings and stuff, so let me just make
sure. My internet's a little bit been a little bit recently too, so but I haven't lost anything, so
great.
But anyway, Logan Xavier, well, let's not beat around the bush. I was asked by Zombie Apocalypse to go ahead and I was asked desperately to babysit one night. I think Zombie Apocalypse had some kind of there's some sort of award, some sort of like, it was like a white tie event that was going on that he was called away, and Zombie Apocalypse was on the picture. They need somebody to look after little Logan Xavier, and said, I need you to do me a solid, man, because you know how I saved your life, which is a whole other toast. That one can you help me out today? And I said, of course, it's you, man. I got your back. And I hadn't really, I mean, the thing is, I've got two kids of my own, but to be honest, I kind of let them do their own thing. I don't really bond with them or anything. And so you know, it's like, that's more than the mom's worry. At least it was at the time. What I did was I didn't think something to do with this kid, something to do. And I said, I think of nothing better than to give some sort of life skill. And I said, we're going to build some shelves. I actually said, fuck it too, which would prove that I wasn't very good, because I said, fuck it, let's build some shelves. He went, fuck it. And I went, you don't say that in front of
Nutty Poppers. Don't.
And we put up, shelves all over the house. Seriously. Like all different kinds, like some that like went directly in the wall, some that had like little joist kind of things, on them, some intricate, like ornate, like iron bars underneath them, some bookshelves, some shelves for the spices, all over the house. I thought it was great. Zombie Apocalypse didn't appreciate it when he came home and like everything had been completely covered in shelves all over his house. But you know what the point is? I learned how to be a better parent that day. We were closer, and I think Logan and Xavier and I definitely. We definitely bonded. We had a good time, and hit a couple of strip clubs after that.
Hell,
so it's
yeah.
a great night.
That's Cheers. Fantastic. Cheers. Cheers. Also, I love that you put the brawn and the brain in that name. There you go. You get both with that name. All right. Fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the cocktail stream. I am Holden. I'm your number one dream. This is my buddy Jeff. He could be a ref. He could tell you what the rules are. He could, I ran out of steam on rhyming things. Kathy Ops, welcome.
Yeah, there
Jeff's
we go.
Jeff's mother is in the house, right, in his house, as Snoopy Dog would say.
Everybody watched me text you earlier. We were actually doing this, Mom, and so in real
Beautiful.
Time, we texted, because I realized I forgot to tell you this earlier.
Well, we had Easter. We had Easter this past Sunday. We actually celebrated it. I think Lexi's just getting cagey and sort of losing her mind, so she's sort of forced a full Easter celebration upon me, which I did quite enjoy. We watched Jesus Christ Superstar, the John Legend one that NBC rebroadcast at 7. Bring back Slow Talking Boris. I will think about it. What's new in the news? We dyed Easter eggs. You fox. And we also did a competition. Oh my god, a man baby Kathy Offs gifted a sub from I Don't Really Play Video Games, who has gifted almost 150 subs to this stream, and we greatly appreciate it. Thank you so much.
You gifted several to my mother too, and I appreciate
yeah?
it.
There you go. Happy Easter and Hail Satan, absolutely. Alchemy Steve, of course. So she also made us do this other thing, which is sort of forcing me to do nice things for her, albeit I do get nice things back. We did an Easter egg hunt. Lexi hid her eggs in the bedroom. I hid my eggs in the living room based off of a coin toss. We took in each egg, there were 3 eggs each, 6 total. And each egg
is back here. Hey, good to see
you. Yeah, what's
you?
Up,
but I haven't seen Indigo's in a
Welcome to the stream. We had to put little notes in every egg, and the note would say something that you would do for the other person. And the first person to find all 3 eggs got 2 of the it was so complicated. But either way, we had to write things we have to do for each other, some sexy things, some nice things. I said one of the ones she found first, which means I have to do it for her. Is I have to what was it? Oh, plan a romantic evening in with my lava. Yeah, a lot of like things like that, so it's fine.
Yeah.
It was very cute. We did that, and she just loved it and had a great time. But we dyed our eggs. Actually, you can see our dyed eggs behind us on the counter. She got a bunch of candy, which I'm upset with her about. And it was good. No
can
foot rub.
That you and your wife did more for each other than Lindsay and I did for our children.
So what did you guys? So what did first of all?
We treated it like a Sunday. We didn't have any candy. We didn't, because all a kid cares about is candy. The only place I know where I can get candy in that kind of bulk is the Walgreens nearest. I forgot it was even Easter.
What's up, K-Brown?
And I was like, it's like, I can't go wait in line because they only let a couple people in the Walgreens at the same time. It's the slowest Walgreens in the entire world. And it's like, it takes forever even on a normal day. But yeah, there's, when you've got like 20 people waiting in line outside to even get in.
Brutal.
It's like, I'm not, I can't.
By the way, that's
this.
What's going on here. I don't know if that's happening for you guys, but that's going on here, like, everywhere. Like, you have to wait now in a weirdly spaced out line. But it's important. I'm glad they're doing it.
Yeah.
I'm glad they're taking these precautions. But you have to wait in a weirdly spaced out line out front of the store now. And they only let a certain amount of people in at a time to not have too much crowding. And so you are waiting forever. Once you get in the store, it's pretty cool, though. Because, like, no one's in there. And for New York, that's a weird feeling. And you can just get whatever you want whenever you want. That's not COVID.
We got
that's
the COVIDs.
Weed. That's not COVID. It's weed. I also worked out, of course. I've been streaming my Ring Fit exercises. Thanks, everybody, for joining me on that. Alchemy Steve, find a way to hide your Easter egg clues in the Dark Souls next year. I should do that. I should fucking do that. I can put little messages on the ground for Lexi to find. Also, something, I guess. I hope you're enjoying Sekiro. I cannot stop thinking about the Final Fantasy VII Remake, and all I want to do is play it. So what are we drinking tonight, K Brown? That's a great question. So we are drinking tonight the Dealer's Choice, which is based on the available contents of your liquor cabinet. Step one is going to be blank parts blank. In my case, I made a Bloody Mary to start things off. So I did two parts of vodka, and Jeff, it's two parts bourbon, specifically
Bullet Rye.
Bullet Rye. Step two, blank parts blank. He did, I believe it was half a shot of Cherry Hearing?
Half a shot of cherry hearing, yep.
Hearing cherry liqueur, rather. And I did, for my Bloody Mary, four shots of tomato juice. Step three is add blank and or blank. I added pepper, Tabasco sauce, rather, and Worcestershire sauce. Jeff just dipped his balls in the drink and just said, Bolly ball, look at my fun Bolly balls, which I thought was a weird thing to do. Also, though, he added Lalette, and
that was the important part. The balls was the most important part.
Of course, and
part of Lalette and a couple drops of Reagan's Orange Bitters.
Step four: shake/stir with ice and pour, and enjoy your blank. In my case, Bloody Mary, and in Jeff's case, a Sherlock, his signature Sherlock drink. And as you can see, I've got my Bloody right there. Jeff has his Sherlock right there. Actually, not too far off color-wise, which is kind of hilarious. But yeah, Udigooz did hit me up to find out what the ratios of those margaritas were again the other night because they were so good. I really loved them. Well, dipping the nuts really seals in the flavor, absolutely. It's honestly better than mulling an orange peel inside of the drink. It kind of just... It just opens the doors up on the drink, flavor-wise. It opens the fucking doors up, chat. And I'm about to open the doors up on your consciousness. That's right. We're going to go deep, we're going to go hard, and we're going to be so weird. You're about to, why can't I be funny? Jeff, save three funny things. Now. Too slow.
Butts. Penises. And boobies.
Jeez Louise.
I'm spending my time with 6-year-old girls. They would think that was fucking hilarious.
Butt sack bitters, absolutely. And mold testicle cider, absolutely. Yo, what's up, Germany? How you doing? Ready? Thank you so much. Garnish with Jake's pubes and drink topper, absolutely. Please. Jake has the very floral pubes. That's what's so good about them.
Whoa, is that very fucking Seinfeld with those jokes? Wait.
Yeah, right? Holden, I'm like 30 hours deep in FF7 and my brain is so happy. I hope yours is too. I am just loving it. I wish I had more time to play it. I'm about to go try to chat with Mr. Don Corneo, and I am so excited about it. Yeah, Square Knot. It is just so damn good. And I hope I'm not spoiling anybody by saying I'm going to go see Don Corneo. Tin from Zombie Apocalypse, thank you so much. And let me see if you wrote a message. I don't know why the messages are being weird. Holden, your karaoke song is Crash Test Dummies. I was actually considering doing this one when I had my own choice the other night. Reminds me of Slow Talk of Morris. Thank you for your boy. All right, get out of here, please, slow tug of war's. So, yeah, but Don Corneo, I feel like you kind of knew that was probably going to happen. The Wall Market part is my favorite so far. Dude, I'm so excited about it, Darcy. You have no clue. All right, so yeah, that's been a big one for me, FF7 Remake. I played it most of the day and night on Saturday. I will probably do the same this Saturday. Nice! Emilio Spaceman's grandmother is finally home from the hospital after having COVID, so I'm having a pretty good day. That's amazing. God, it's such a relief, isn't it? When you find out you or your loved one is no longer, potentially gonna, you know, be fucked up by this thing, or be in a sad, scary place by this thing. Especially grandmother, man. Woo! Fantastic, man. Congratulations on that. That must feel awesome. And hey, kudos to, cheers to your grandmother for being a badass B-word and pushing through that whole S-word viral situation. I used to have horrifying nightmares where I was having a normal speed conversation with people who all talked like slow talking Morris, and it was real upsetting. all right, yo, what's up? What was the dream? So, what else has happened this week? Yeah, so we did more than you did for your daughters on Easter. That's very interesting and sad. Did you used to do anything as a child for Easter? I know for me, I was this is a little bit of a walk back through memory lane. I was telling Lexi, because she had never dyed eggs before. I was like, oh, we always dyed eggs.
Dyeing eggs. That was what that's what you did as a kid for me.
I always dyed eggs the day before, and then in the morning, my parents would have hid the eggs all over the house or all over the living room or whatever, and then we'd run around and we find all the eggs. It was a big deal who got the most eggs, my brother or I, and then we would have like a basket of candy and stuff that we would be waiting for us as well, and we'd eat the candy. I remember they'd always give us she's a man baby. I don't even know. Oh, it's because the lurp. Oh, is that why it's been cutting it off? One karaoke song for each of you. You choose the song. Thank you so much. So greatly appreciate it. That might have been why we weren't seeing the messages, because Zoom was in the way. Apologies for that. So maybe everything's fine. Thank you so much. So greatly appreciate it, buddy. Hi, Instant 3 Play. Good to see you, man. And then, yeah, that was pretty much it. It was pretty basic. It wasn't super religious or anything. But we did dye the eggs, get the candy, find the eggs. That we did, for sure. And, yeah, exactly. My alert box.
Can you hear a lot? Can you hear a lot of Powerpuff Girls music in the background?
Not really. I can barely hear it, though, for sure. Okay. You're fine, though.
No, I think we're okay.
Flashback to Jay and Silent Bob beating up Easter Bunny and Mallrats. Loved that. Loved Mallrats. It's a scooter. Schooner. What? Yeah, no, you idiot. It's a boat. Schooner is a boat. Oh, my God. How fantastic. Also love Chasing Amy. Of course, my name is Holden McNeely. And Chasing Amy is Holden McNeil. And he does get together with a lesbian woman, bi woman, which is fun and similar. We were able to do an egg hunt for the niece and nephew. Very nice. That's a good way to, you know, it's good to do. Also, yeah, I don't think anybody's going to be upset about Powerpuff Girls music, even if they can hear it.
Original Powerpuff Girls, of course, not that crap 2016 remake.
Yeah. None of that nonsense. Get that out of here.
Yeah.
F that with a B.
I'm irrationally angry about the 2016 to 2018 Powerpuff Girls.
What else have we done not leaving the apartment? I got the Control DLC, which I'm greatly enjoying, but it did make me think back on your lament that it was too difficult. And I will say the DLC is like very hard. And I kind of remember you talking about it. I was like, yeah, this is a bit much, actually. Like, especially the DLC. I don't know. How far do you think you got into that game? You played it for a while. I mean, you got...
I did. I just kept... I don't know if I got that far. I just kept... I mean, I consistently get my ass handed to me. Almost every fight. Early on, it was fine. But then when they just like kept respawning and just like it kept going crazier and crazier, it was like, I can't do this anymore.
I probably
know more than 20 in, I'll bet.
Okay. I 20 hours in. Something I guess had the same issue. I think the main thing I read early on that helped me out was to put all your points into the throw stuff ability.
Mm-hmm.
What's wrong with you? Why can't I think of the word for it?
Something I guess agrees with you.
Yeah, I know. I see that.
Oh, I'm sorry. If I repeat something you said, by the way, it's like every now and then, right now, you're like skipping a little bit in the Zoom.
No worries. You were skipping a little bit earlier, but sorry if it might be a struggle tonight for you, Jeff. But just keep getting more drunk, and it'll just seem normal.
Well, when we do the
suicide shot. Yeah,
later on. Which if you guys, any of you who don't know, Square Knot donated to do a shot of like. We're going to do 10 different things in our respective liquor cabinets.
Tonight's drink is dealer's choice, which is literally whatever you have in your liquor cabinet, right? That's the ingredients. Mm-hmm. Blank parts blank, blank parts blank, add blank and or blank, shake/stir with ice and pour and enjoy your blank. So right now I'm having a Bloody Mary. Jeff is having his signature Sherlock drink. The suicide shot, which is a secret incentive, $100 incentive, which has already been fulfilled, so don't even think about doing it again because we're not doing it twice, we will pour 10 things into a glass from our selection here. But we have a couple rules. You're only allowed one bitters. We're doing...
Two bitters.
We're doing three liquors. We're doing five... liqueurs, and we're doing two bitters. Whiskey and tequila does not count as a mix.
I promised that I'm going to put
similar. Oh yeah, I'm doing for mine. I have to do gin, vodka, and whiskey, which I am not looking forward to.
With mine, I did. You also promised you're going to put tomato juice in it,
and I also promised I would put tomato juice in mine, and you promised you would put absinthe in yours.
Yeah,
that's the other thing.
Which is probably stupid.
Which is probably dumb. We should actually probably say it's got to be a certain amount, like a quarter shot of each. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I mean...
A quarter shot of each. Because $100, we got to go big or go home. You know what I mean? So we got to really give the money's worth on that. So again, thank you, Square Knot, for that. And we got some karaoke coming up, dude. I'm excited for that. My big old beanbags, my below parts... are screaming for some karaoke because I can't get hard unless I'm doing singing songs based off of YouTube videos that I pull up on the internet. Ladies and gentlemen, how's it going? How are things? This is the first hour, and so we're just kind of having a little share time. All I've been doing is playing, the Control DLC. I beat the Resident Evil 3 remake way too quickly because it's way too short. But I've been enjoying that and just playing that Final Fantasy VII remake like it's going out of style. But I did check out the live theatrical performance of Fleabag with Phoebe Waller-Bridge. And that was a fantastic time. And I also, I saw Emma, the new Emma film, which would be good. Fuck, I'll have to be back. I have to focus. Don't do the suicide until I get back. Yeah, we're going to do it in the last hour, Square Knot. We're going to do it in the final hour for sure. Maybe top of the final hour.
When it will do the most damage.
Yeah, because like top of the final hour, we'll be pretty lit up, but we'll also have to continue to do like 45 minutes of, it sounds like an entire freshman party in a shot glass. It's going to be terrible. This ends at 10 o'clock. Yeah, we're going till 10. And you know what? Actually, why don't I just jump? Your hair looks so good. Who's your incredibly beautiful stylist? I must know. Lexi. She did it. Lexi cut my hair on stream last Friday, and it was a lot of fun, and I had a great time.
I decided to not. I'm just not going to cut my hair until... I was thinking about growing a little bit longer anyway, but we'll see what happens.
What does your hair do when it gets very long?
It just kind of bells out. It just goes out and this, yeah.
Do you have to ponytail it or something? Mine just froze out. Mine just becomes broop. It just becomes a dome.
Well, the weight of it kind of keeps it down. It's at a point, it definitely, it has a natural body to it, but also, but it kind of goes like that. So it's too heavy to go straight up.
I had to go stash only because I wear a mask for work. Yeah, do I need to cut my beard off because of the mask situation?
Robot Jeff?
Is the beard just stupid to wear if I have to wear a mask to go out? What's the problem? Is it just uncomfortable for you, or is it actually just dumb to have a beard if you have to wear it? I don't really go out that much anymore. So I saw grocery stores with beer. It's hard and I sweat. Ah, I see. First burp of the night. Ooh, and first... shit. Just shit my pants. N95 requires a clean shave. I can't get those good masks. I can only get those bad masks. We bought masks from a store that sells brooms and flour and other sort of random items, pool floaties. You know what I mean? It's like one of those places. And they had a sign out front that just said, "We sell mask." And so we got the mask from there. And of course, it's not a very quality product. Any advice for convincing my wife to cut my hair? It's getting so shaggy and she's apprehensive about cutting it. All right, first of all, Kay Brown, do you have clippers? If you get clippers, I would say it's intimidating to cut hair with scissors, period. But if you get clippers and sit down with her and show her a YouTube tutorial video, I think she'll find that it's really not that bad. It's really not that hard. Because you just, with the clippers, you just put it at a setting and you just go... that's it. You know what I mean? Dog shears work for you, yeah. Very good. Grow your beard to be a mask. That's true. I could have a beard mask. That'd be fantastic. Well, ladies and gentlemen.
I got our masks. I got four of them for all of us. I got some deli nearby, which has actually been, generally speaking, better stocked than some of the grocery stores in this area.
Uh-huh.
That's the first place I was able to find toilet paper and paper towels and stuff. Was at this weird
right
deli near where we used to live.
Interesting. Trying to figure out how to do this the best.
Those naps are good though.
Let's see. All right, I'm gonna do this first karaoke song. Jeff, entertain while I set this up.
Okay. Well, I'm actually curious what people are doing. What are you doing to keep yourself? What to have fun? I mean, I know we're probably playing. We're all playing games and stuff. There's some parents in there,
and homeschool
our kids. We have to which takes up a tremendous amount of time. I hope America comes away from this quarantine with so much more respect for teachers than it currently has.
I weirdly have less respect for teachers.
What?
They're just whatever. You know what I mean?
Yeah, man, it's a part-time job. You didn't do anything. watching Holden's fucking stream. Why else would I be here?
I mean, I guess that is true.
Paint video games, workout, paint video games, repeat. Here we go.
See, I've still got work. I've got so much work. I'm so busy.
Yeah, well, that's the thing. Yeah, with you, you're you were more prepared for this than.
Yeah, I was already not leaving and just working all the time, so.
I'm trying to do, I had a little freelance, I had some freelance work that I did that I kind of finished up, and now I'm, that's coming to a pretty hard end now, so.
Not to make people feel bad, but I have to work.
I'm trying to go back into learning, I've been trying to teach myself Adobe Premiere and After Effects, so probably go back into that.
All right, here's the first song of the night, I finally got it set up.
I might mute myself so you don't get Powerpuff music coming in.
Yeah, I wasn't aware of the quarantine till last week. Yeah, absolutely. I was just working from home. All right. Here we go. Stop this music. Here we go. Mm-mm-mm-mm by the Crash Test Dummies. Let's rock it. Oh, shit.
There was this kid who got into an accident and couldn't come to school, but when he finally came back, his hair had turned from black into bright white. He said that it was from when the car had smashed. So
I used to play this tape on repeat. I legitimately really enjoyed them.
Once there was this girl who couldn't go and change with the girls in the change room, but when they finally made her, they saw birthmarks all over her body.
Someone isn't in chat aggressively rubbing their thighs right now, I don't know, you're doing it wrong.
But both the girl and boy were glad, cause one kid had worse than that.
Which kid is that?
When there was this boy whose parents made him come directly home right after school, and lurch all over the church floor. Couldn't quite explain it. It always just gone there.
Ow! To it, order from it, whatever. I don't know what it does. I don't know what it wants you to do. Chat, welcome to the stream. You're my creamy Sunday dream, but it's Monday, so we have to wake up sometimes. Okay, chat. And that goes for all of us. All right. So if everybody, oh cool, it just pops up. If I pop it up, that's cool.
Tune
Groucho Club, dude. I love that whole album. I really love that whole album. It's not Kara OK, it's Kara Fun. Hire me, I'm a marketer. It's like watching a middle school Dare magic act, but there's no magic. Yeah. What is no magic? Thank you, Mally. I'm glad you were aggressively rubbing your sort of thighs or whatever. This song's a real thigh rubber. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we are in the second hour already of cocktails, and we've only had one drink, and we need to fix that situation, brother man.
I'm thinking about doing Manhattan next, but like a different kind of Manhattan. All I'm right. Still working on this though, so I'm you do your next one, I'll be good.
All right, I'm gonna do something similar. I think I'm gonna do cherry hearing with sweet vermouth. This is what I'm gonna do.
Cherry Herring with sweet vermouth?
What do you think? No? Should I do
it? With just the two of those together?
No, I'm in a bourbon.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, yeah. Okay. I thought you were saying Cherry Herring with sweet vermouth.
And oh.
I was distracted because Princess Morbux is the villain on the episode of Powerpuff Girls that's going on over there. And so,
I gotta stop rubbing my thighs. My God, what have I done? I love Crash Test Dummies, dude.
I'm happy for you.
Well, what are you making? Maybe we should make the same thing this time, Jeff.
Okay, well, let's both do a version of a Manhattan. That means a bourbon or a rye, like two parts of bourbon or rye to one part sweet vermouth, and then a bitters of your choosing.
All right.
We'll do that, and if you want to add a little bar spoon of the cherry. Of the cherry hearing in. I'll make a nice little.
Okay, we'll add a little hearing.
Yeah, I'm gonna do Knob Creek bourbon, 100 proof.
I'm gonna do bourbon, and so
Dolan Rouge Vermouth, and I don't know what kind of bitters.
Got
am I
the
doing
Rouge here? Vermouth.
Yeah.
And bitters wise, I think I'm going to go with these black walnut bitters that Lexi just got.
I'll find something that kind of excites me when I get back there.
Find something a little special. I'll rub my thighs while you go grab that, okay?
All right. Yeah. Let me grab this.
So, chat, just what are we feeling right now, huh? And if this entices you, relax into it. Just feel it. Just be cool with it, okay? Don't report me, all right? I'm not rubbing any genitalia, just my thighs. But what are you guys thinking right now? You know what I mean? Should I go the other way, switch? Do a little counterclockwise action? This is counterclockwise, right? Can I do two different directions? No, that's the same direction. I don't know if that's possible. All right, my arms are getting tired. Ugh! All right, great, good timing.
So I'm gonna go with this, two parts of this, one part of this, and I decided to go with some, make it interesting, do some chocolate rose bitters. This was made for me by Jared, Daddy Jared's ex-girlfriend.
So, she's nice.
She makes good bitters.
No, she was fine. All right, so first we're doing, you said, two shots of bourbon?
Yeah, you know, I just realized. Yeah, do two shots of bourbon, one shot of the vermouth, and then dash or couple dashes, whatever you want, of the bitters. I just realized I didn't bring myself a clean glass or any ice or anything, so I need to disappear for again.
A second. I need to grab a shot glass.
Pretend this is a real show.
I don't need to grab a shot glass. Never mind. I just need to watch this.
Commercial break happening right now.
That's all chat. We're good. Oh God, I didn't watch this out. I didn't watch this out either. Damn it. It's all right. It's a more complicated version of what we normally do. Okay, for the love of the Lord, relax. Chat. I'm still here. I want to spend like $150 of my stimulus money on setting up a home bar. What are your suggested essentials? That's a great question. I'm going to wait for Jeff to get back to answer it. I'd say definitely, like, one thing that you want to get a basic assortment of bitters. I would go with Agnes Shura bitters. Pei Shao's bitters, which we don't have, and this Regan's orange bitters. I think that's a good basic spread for bitters to start you off. You're gonna want vermouth, Lillet, this right here, Lillet, sweet vermouth, maybe dry vermouth as well. And then of course, obviously a nice bottle of Campari you'll want. You can always get grenadine as well. And then I would say, the basic spirits, whiskey, tequila, I'd get a bourbon and a rye, gin,
and some vodka. Yeah, I'd say that. But
what was the question you were answering?
The question was, I want to spend like $150 of my stimulus money on setting up a home bar. What are your suggested essentials? Also, this bar tool is fantastic. This is from Gentleman's Hardware, and Jeff and I each have one of these. I have confiscated his for now because he left it here. But yeah, this is like a Swiss Army knife bar tool that I just feel like is an all-in-one for a baby's first bar setup. I think it works really well. All right, let's mix. So
two parts bourbon.
Oh, that was a little extra there. A little extra for the doctor. Twin Peaks, thanks for the Whisper episode on DDR. My early Mother's Day gift was a set of dance pads and 40 DDR games. That's fucking badass. That's mad, I guess. Dude, I'm not looking forward to this suicide drink.
You doing vermouth now, or?
Yeah, one part vermouth, right?
Yep.
All right.
Any kind of vermouth, really.
Yeah, yeah.
You can do a white vermouth. You can do a rouge. You can do dry vermouth.
Is white dry and rouge sweet? Is that how it works?
No, white is actually a different kind. They're dry and white are different.
Okay.
It's not really common. I just recently kind of discovered a
black walnut vermouth, bitters.
Actually, a blanc vermouth, and it's really good. It's refreshing. It's nice.
Kathy Ops, I agree. Hopefully, we can do that. Well, maybe someone bored at home during quarantine should start putting together that cocktails book. That would be interesting.
It's on my list, right?
Did we say we were going to add some cherry hearing or no?
I wouldn't put a lot in. Put maybe like, because you don't want to make it too sweet with a vermouth, but maybe put like a little bar spoon or something in.
A little drop will do you.
Drop, yeah.
Perfect. That was maybe a little more than I should have, but what are you going to do? Someday my prince will come. This is one of my favorite. This Someday My Prince Will Come by Bill Evans off of Portrait and Jazz. Fantastic. One of my favorite jazz songs of all time. I feel like Jeff should be wearing a lab coat and pouring drinks into beakers. I know, right? SF Experiments? Agreed. He's got that mad science. I'm surprised you haven't done like written yourself as like a mad scientist in anything, Jeff.
Yeah, not yet.
All right, here we go.
All right.
Cheers.
Cheers, everyone.
I see you're working with a rock there.
That's lovely.
That is also lovely. Man, those black walnut bitters really are expressive. Usually I don't taste the bitters.
Sounds good. Obviously, I would... I'm sure there's some kind of actual, like, nut extract in it. I wouldn't be able to have it because I'm allergic to nuts. But
dude, I've been having a major nut extract these days, if you know what I mean. I've been just furiously.
What else are you gonna do?
Pulling on myself during this quarantine.
Mine's the chocolate rose.
Very nice that Jared's the woman that broke Jared's heart made that for you. Isn't that interesting?
Well, she broke his heart. But.
All right, Guy Montag knows what I'm talking about. Yo, she's a mambi with 10 for Swishbot. Here's an 80s jam for either one of you to sing. Thank you so much. Probably gonna go to Jeff if it's an 80s jam. Speaking of going to Jeff, Jeff, why don't you regale us with a karaoke song of your choice? Whatever you want, just let me know when you're ready. I'll keep up with chat. Until then, ropes and ropes. It's unbelievable. I feel like
I am
13 again. With the amount of sort of various sort of
my friend Matt Sears,
what's up?
My friend Matt Sears, who plays Clarf, the Squirrel Man in Space Captain Space, just sent. To do this, he just sent me a text saying, "Dash, which is his son, who's actually about the girl's age, he's 6 years old, just watched Space Captain and is raving about it. At the end, he wrapped an arm around my shoulders and said, 'I can't believe I ever saw a movie with you in it.'" He said, "Thanks for making that a moment in my life."
Wow.
Very, very sweet.
That's so sweet. Oh my God. That is so sweet.
I have to write back to him. That's so nice.
Well, don't cry or whatever. It's fine that it happened, but it's whatever. I've done a lot of meaningful things for people too. So a lot of people have thanked me for stuff. I can't think of any right now, but there's definitely people who are like, oh, you changed my life. You know, my child, my relationship with my child's better. They've said that about me many times, Jeff. They've said that their child and them get along better or whatever because of some fucking dumb shit I said, all right? So it's fine. Or like I put them in a play or whatever that I wrote. I should write something. What should I write about, guys? Which I should write a long form piece.
We should write a Twitcher meme where it's all just done over Zoom.
We could. I mean, SNL just did it. So.
Yeah.
Yeah. Shoutouts, by the way, to Michael Che for hanging in there, having some rough times, losing a grandparent to COVID. I can't imagine. I'm so scared for my parents.
Oh, my God.
What? Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's, yeah. I'm getting, like, peripheral people, you know, in my life, you know, who are, like, losing loved ones to COVID. It's
bummer. We'll try not to focus. Yo, Square Knight, congratulations on getting that paper in. Write a story about a world of musicals where it all just happens to be in the usher's head and he's on his deathbed. I guess I could write that fucking tale.
I think I got
you ready.
I think so. Let me oops.
The bee is subtle and subtle.
Karaoke.
I didn't even think about how the bee is subtle and subtle. Let me know when you're ready and I'll pause the music on my end.
Okay. Oops.
There's this idea that in portraiture is...
Let's go ahead and turn that off for a second.
Five-time roundtable of the year, Michael Che, absolutely. Absolutely. Wow. It's always... Monday hits me like a truck, man, I feel like. And I get to this stream and I'm just like, what happened? I feel like I'm way busier on Sunday than I normally used to be. But now, in order to catch up on the week of research, I have to do a lot of work on Sunday now. So I feel like Monday is Tuesday, and then Friday is like more like a Saturday for me. Whatever, though, who gives a shit? How boring was that whole conversation I just had with myself? Are you ready? I'm tired
of
talking.
I'm ready to go. Let me make sure I get this.
Sick of my own voice.
So I'm not gonna be able to see chat, so tell me if you can't hear me through the thing, if you can't hear the music or something.
I could definitely hear, what was that, Bob Ross talking, so I feel like we'll be all right. Just turn the volume up as loud as you want.
All right.
On the music.
All right. Here we go.
Well, I could hide neath the wings of the bluebird as she sings. 6 o'clock alarm would never ring, but it rings and I rise right to sleep out of my eyes. The shaving razor is cold and it stings. Cheer up, sleepy Jean.
Rub those thighs, Chad. You know you want to.
So I daydream, believer, and a homecoming queen. Once startled me as a white knight on a steed. Now you know how happy I can be. And our good time starts and ends with a dollar on the screen. But how much, baby, do cheer up, sleepy Jean.
Do
I daydream,
believer?
Kind of singing behind me a little bit in the background.
cheer up, Snoopy G. What can it be to a daydream believer and a homecoming king? Cheer up, Snoopy G.
Awesome! I give my blood to that. I would give you a quart of blood for that.
Oh, thank you so much.
I watched Cats last night. It was awful. You're fine. It left me confused and uncomfortable. Why was the only cat who got boobs T-Swift? What does Jellicle mean? These are all very important questions. I was left with so many questions, so many few answers. Noob, I hope you were on edibles at least for that. I was on so many edibles for that. I didn't know what world I was in anymore. I thought I was going to stay in Cat's world.
I feel like I have to point out because SFX Experiments said extra point to Jeff for making his bed in quarantine. That's not actually my bed. The bedroom, is disaster. You would not want to go in there, but this is the front room. That's like a day bed that we bought off some friends of ours. It's like a little like a guest bed, so I can't take credit for making my bed during this,
man. Baby, thank you so much for the sub, shoe paste. Ooh, shoe, I'm gonna sing you a song now, shoe paste. Ooh, shoe paste, you're the king of my world. King of my world, but you're never gonna be my girl. And don't you forget it, I will break your heart. And I will flick you out, and I will ghost you, girl. And I will give you a shout when you're dead and gone. Dead and gone, when Shoopay's dead and gone, when he's dead and gone, and I'll be the one, he'll be the one, to shove him off a cliff, to push him in front of a train, to cut his fucking neck, to shoot a gun into his brain. And don't you forget it, coming after you. Gonna hire a man to throw a spike-covered shoe right at your face. Oh, yeah, gonna shoot you in outer space. Oh, no, gonna make you cry. Oh, yeah, gonna make you die. Oh, yeah, gonna smell your guts. Gonna rip open your butt. Gonna taste your thigh. Gonna make you cry. Shoebase gonna cry. Shoebase gonna cry. Shoebase is gonna motherfucking cry. I'm gonna take his balls and I'm gonna keep him as a trophy on my wall. I'm gonna keep his balls as a trophy. Wall. Ooh, 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 paste. Ooh, paste. Ooh.
I gotta touch my nipples.
I'm no longer near a school. That congratulations, thank you, Shoepace. You're welcome, and I hope you enjoyed that immensely. This is the cocktails show where we are classy men. We drink classy cocktails, and I'll tell you what. In a half an hour, I'm pulling out the question cup, and we're gonna answer some questions. So there you go. No one's ever serenaded me like that. No one's ever gonna serenade you like that again. Not only because it's so unique and special, but also because I really straight am gonna fucking find you and kill you, dude. Feel like a whole new man now? Absolutely.
You've said this many times before. You were saying it after the stream. We stayed on Zoom for a little while after the stream last week, and he was saying he was gonna kill you, so you may want
you may want
to take precautions, my friend.
You may want to kind of, this is essentially what I would suggest to you, bro. I would suggest to you, I don't care if you have a baby girl, you gotta take that baby girl, and you need to never stay anywhere for more than 3 days honestly, I'd leave after two if I were you and try to get out of the country. Good fucking luck during the pandemic. Classic Cocktail Holden's different than Friday Night Sleepover Holden. Absolutely, it is. I'm very different. This is the
gentleman's. You said in a half hour we were going to start doing we were going to start doing questions, but before that, at 9 p.m., I believe we're doing the suicide shot.
At 9 p.m., we're doing the suicide shot brought to you by the Square Knot, who funded the secret donation incentive, which was for $100, we will do a suicide shot. What that means is, since tonight's stream is, of course, dealer's choice, which means the ingredients are the available contents of your liquor cabinet. So I have just a shitload of alcohols here, different little beverages and things, different things, right? And I'm gonna combine 10 of them, okay? And so is Jeff. It has to be 3 liquors, 5 liqueurs, and do I even have enough liqueurs? Yeah, I probably have enough liqueurs. 1, 2, 3, 4.
You don't just do an extra shot.
5, 6. That's no. It has to be 10 different things. And then I'm going to say 2 bitters, or, like in my case, one of those will probably be the tomato juice. You know what I mean? Or like a non-alcoholic.
One will probably be one of the bitters will be replaced by a little bit of absinthe.
And for him, he has to do absinthe. Yeah, it's going to be rough. We'll do a quarter shot of each thing. I think that'll be okay. And we have to finish it.
Lindsay's had a headache for a couple days, and
well, you're about to have a fucking headache. For a couple
so that headache right out.
So, it's gonna be so tough, man.
She laughed mockingly in the room.
It's gonna be so tough, man. Well, I hate to follow a song with a song, but I owe the donation incentive for it.
Yeah, this is like a special. Sorry, but the girls conned Lindsay into watching like an especially long episode of Powerpuff Girls, and so. Yeah. Have them come over and say goodnight to everybody before.
I will.
3 more minutes. Okay.
All right. So here we go. My song is I Am the Walrus by the Beatles. Let's get into this. This is my pick. Thank you again, by the way, for the donation that came in for me to do this. This is coming from... Soat, thank you so much. We also have an 80s jam to sing in a little while. Maybe we'll do that right before our suicide shot. So here we go. Let's do this. Right, I got to get British.
Oh, I gotta need this one.
You know I'm the walrus. How they fly. I'm crying, sitting on a cornflake, waiting for the vet to come. Corporation t-shirt, stupid bloody Tuesday. Man, you've been a Nazi boy, you let your face grow long. I am the Eggman. Ooh, I am the Eggman. Ooh. In the sky, see how they run. I'm crying. I'm crying. I'm crying. Yeah, I'm out of custard. Dripping from a dead dog's eye. Grab a lock of fishwife, photographic greases. Boy, you've been an Nazi girl, you let your knickers down. I am the Eggman. Ooh, I am the Eggman. Ooh, I am the walrus. Goo 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 goo. Oh shit. Is this some booner tunes? Boomer tunes. Everybody, I feel like I was pregnant with whatever that was, and I just gave birth to it. Now, yeah, he said Paul is the walrus in a different song about onions or whatever. Who gives? You know what I mean? It's like whatever, dude. John does look kind of walrus-like. I mean, that is true. Holden's voice got me tripping face, and I didn't even need to take drugs, dude. Hell yeah, bro. Dude, I want what he's having. I wish my own voice could make me fucking high, dude. I'd be high all the time. All right, let's kick it back. You're going to do a song in a little while, Jeff.
Hey.
But until then, let's just kick it, dude. It's like, what is everybody screaming about these days? We have to make another drink soon.
Yeah. Well, I'm still... I might wait till... I'm going to see if Lindsay actually is up to it. Because like I said, she's been a little bit under the weather. Not the COVIDs. But... something else, and so
she might have it. Headaches body. Is a symptom.
She might take over. Yeah, but she doesn't have the fever or the body aches or
right.
chill or any of that.
Or any of the loss of smell is a big one.
Yeah, my daughter Violet. I don't know. I mean, we're like social distancing or anything, so I have no idea how she managed to get like this like little head cold that she got recently. But I think
maybe she did something. Mean Certainly to a witch or something. That's always my guess, is that she like accidentally stepped on a witch's foot or something and she didn't know it was a witch and the witch went home and gave her
She did. Headaches. There was an old like, you know, lady who was very witch-like and she like stepped on her and she laughed at her and she farted on her.
Right.
And said, "Hey, you smell like fart." And because
yeah,
that's funny because
it.
It's a girl.
Textbook.
And I was like, "Honey, that girl's a witch. That lady is a witch. She's you're doing something that's going to come back and it's going to there's going to be repercussions for this." And she didn't laugh at me. She said, "Shut the fuck up, old
right.
man. I got to raise my kids better," is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, that's definitely a bad.
Yeah.
That's definitely really bad. What was I going to say? I was going to say, I don't know. I thought I had more to talk. I don't know. Chad, what do you got to say? Oh, yeah, I got to make another drink. All right, what are we doing now? I think I'm going to do a gin drink. Now
you're past. Oh wow, I barely touched this one. I did make a double for my first one though, and I was still kind of sipping on that, so I'm a little bit behind. But I think I'm pacing you alcohol wise, but in terms of drinks, you're a little ahead here. But
damn, Squarenuts got the skinny. Lindsay was mean to me in chat, and I paid a witch on YouTube 7 chickens to put a curse in her. So there you go. And I hate that they accept chickens too. That's so evil. Who pooped in the tub? Asked Dr. Daddy Bluetooth. I think it was roommate Mike. Personally, I think it was hungover. He had a big fart. He didn't realize what came out, and what's done is done. And then Lexi stepped in it. My wife stepped in it. We weren't married at the time, and she still married me, which I greatly appreciate it. Damn, remind me not to fuck with y'all. Yeah, 100%. Do not fuck around, K Brown, in this chat, because we are ruthless and we are morality police. We will fucking fuck you up. I still vote Lexi. You don't push someone else's poop down the drain. I mean, it's weird. It doesn't make a lot of sense, for sure. But why would she tell us about it? I mean, wouldn't you be embarrassed? And then that's the whole funny thing. I was just doing a thing because I'm doing a segment for Page 7 called Celebrity Conspiracies. So I was doing, I was reading up on the whole, like, Beyonce being in the Illuminati conspiracy. And it's like, she always throws up these hand signals, you know, and stuff like that. Like, she did that. That's like Jay-Z's hand signal, whatever. It's like, if you're in a secret organization, the last thing you're going to do is at the Super Bowl halftime show with all the cameras on you, put up the secret society's hand signal. I bet Benny's like a monster, especially back then, but he wasn't there. That's his whole thing. Because if someone found a piece of poop that she missed after a shower, she would be judged, so she pushed off the blame. But wouldn't you just get rid of the evidence and then you wouldn't have that problem? I actually heard that one at church law. There you go. Yo, what's up, Nader420? How you doing, man? It was Ben the night before. It could have been Ben the night before, I'm not gonna lie. Bomber12, what's up, dude? Welcome to the stream. Yeah, I guess I'm gonna wash up Jeff entertained while I kind of reset here.
Okay, well, I don't have to entertain anybody. I've got just the people here for it. So, he's got our catfish.
So,
do you want to do more of that dance, Violet?
Oh, gosh.
Go ahead.
Good night. Good night, everybody. Cat.
So, there you go. Alright,
good night. Good night, good night.
And he's drinking. Alright, there you go.
Perfect. That's all I need to do. Thank you so much for that.
We got lots of hellos and highs back, by the way.
Perfect. I love all the people saying goodnight. OMG, yeah. Cute attack.
Goodnight.
That was amazing.
Well, everybody said goodnight to you guys.
I'm so happy now. I hope that cheered everybody up, because I know I've been doing my best to upset you all.
Yeah.
especially shoe-based.
You know, it's funny. I had a really weird moment, actually, when that happened, because they came over here, and it's like, oh, look at my two adorable little sweethearts coming over here. Meanwhile, Dad's just sitting over here in the background, letting mother, who's got a really, really bad like headache and everything, take care of everything. I'm just sitting here drinking. It's just takes you right back to the 1950s.
I know, just drink. Well, yeah, drinking it.
You don't rise the kids, you witch. Who is drinking what? Walter B. Sorry, I need new glasses. Now is a bad time to need glasses. Quaid? Who's drinking what? We're both actually currently drinking, well, holding this finishes. We're drinking Manhattans.
Tonight we were just having Manhattans. Tonight we are drinking the Dealer's Choice, which is the available contents of your liquor cabinet. Step one is blank parts blank. Step two is blank parts blank. Step three is add blank and or blank. Step four, shake slash stir with ice and pour and enjoy your blank. So there you go. So based off of that, I started the night with a Bloody Mary. Jeff is total patriarchy too. I'm going to make a gin drink, Jeff. I'm going to start with two parts gin. What should I put in with that?
Default gin is a Negroni. So it's this equal parts gin, Campari, and sweet vermouth. But you're going to part. Okay, you know what's going to work with that? What kind of gin is it?
Oh, it's really nice. It's like a nice, it's called Hardshore Gin.
Is it more citrusy? Is it more floral?
It smells more floral.
Okay.
Yeah, natural hand-selected botanicals. That seems floral to me.
Yeah. I wonder if the passion fruit stuff might work in it.
Passion fruit? What passion fruit?
Maybe the blue, the alizé, but, yeah. But I'm not sure.
Now let's do one. I want to maybe put the alizé in my suicide drink. So let's do one shot of alizé.
Mm-hmm.
What else?
Square Nut likes Hendrix. That is a good gin.
Hendrix
my
is
favorite
good.
Personally is Green Hook gin. I don't know if that's local. I think it's a local. It is a local New York gin, but I don't know if it's exported or not. But it's really good. If you have a chance to experience some Green Hook gin, I highly recommend.
What else should I do? I've got
okay. What are the other options there?
I've got Contro. I've got the white vermouth.
You know what? That'll be nice and easy. That won't like overpower anything. That go for the white vermouth.
Okay, I'm gonna go for the white vermouth. And is that it?
I might add a bitter to it. Maybe taste it and see. This is like how.
I'll tell you what. I'll throw a orange bitters in there just for.
Can't go wrong.
With the Regans.
Orange bitters never let me down.
Orange bitters. All right. Stay tuned, by the way, and in just about 18 minutes from now, we are going to do the suicide drink. 3 liquors, 5 liqueurs, and 2 bitters or 2 extras. All right, here we go. Stir this up. Smells pretty good. Can really smell that gin, so I hope the gin isn't going to overpower this thing. And I've got
you may have to add more of the other things, but
fresh glass right here. The blue always makes it blue, which I love. I love this color.
55 people watching us get drunk on stream. I love it. I signed off with Twitch first. I did there, and I freaked out.
Black coffee and vodka. Damn, this is great. This tastes amazing. Yes. Yeah.
My first time suggesting some drink things.
Dude, this
over,
tastes awesome.
Yeah.
I'll have to remember
this.
I've
got all those materials. Actually, no, I don't have the. You have my Blanc Vermouth.
I have your Blanc Vermouth. So, again,
I can't get a hold of it for some reason.
This tastes really, really good. 2 shots of gin, a shot of this Blanc Vermouth, a shot of the Alizé. The passion fruit liqueur, blue passion liqueur, and a dash, a couple dashes of the Regan's Orange Bitters. It tastes fantastic.
Great.
You can tell they're suicide drinks because you're both dressed snazzy for your funerals already, exactly. Yeah, it's fantastic.
Somebody in chat, name that drink.
Yeah, what's this drink? The Blue Balls!
There,
the Blue Balls.
Yeah, there you go.
Because if you're not fucking, you better be drinking something. All right, that's the Blue Balls way. The blue makes it blue 100%. I'm not gonna sing the song though, because I hate that song. The blue makes it blue. It does. No, the blue always makes the drink full on blue, in color. There's no escape.
The space champagne, the space captain themed drink we did, because I was using was bourbon or rye that I was using as the base spirit in that. And that combined with the blue passion fruit alizé actually made it green, that which actually worked well for a space champagne anyway.
But, Mommy's Milk and Space Jam are also very good names for it. Ooh, and it's kicking. The liquor is kicking in. I am now. This will be my 6 shots for me. 6 of these. These are like lesser shots, though. I feel like these.
I think it might be actually be an ounce.
Is it? I feel like these are less than shot glass.
I've never tested it. I've never actually...
I should see. Because I feel like those are a little bit less than a normal shot glass, which is good for the purposes of this show, because it's better that we're drinking, like lesser a little bit.
I just realized I've been using most of tonight because the shot glass I have is weird. It's one shot and then one and a quarter shot. And most of the things I've been doing tonight has been the one and a quarter shot. Ah. So you can't hardly tell the difference unless you like look at it sideways for some reason. So I've had extra shots, I think, tonight, which is going to make the suicide shot all the more interesting.
What was I going to say? Oh, I was just dreading the suicide drink.
Yeah.
So what do you think you're going to do for the suicide drink? I'm definitely going to do vodka, gin, and whiskey and bourbon for my liquors. I have to do that. I'm going to do the Alize, the Blanc Vermouth. We'll do the Cherry Hearing liqueur.
Not a mezcal. I was going to do tequila, mezcal, because that works, and then try to think of something else.
What is Contro?
I mean, vodka is pretty inoffensive. Like, I might do. I think I would fuck that up. I don't know. I'll probably do brown. I'll probably do rye, bourbon, and.
Grenadine. And I think I have to do the Lillet. I think I'll do that. Yeah. And then tomato juice. And I will do the Agnostura bitters.
I'll have to bring my computer over to the kitchen and I'll do it all there.
Yes.
We got a couple things here, but
This is my setup over here. Get these fuckers
out. It's in the liquor cabinets. I don't know. Maybe I'll do bourbon, rye, and I don't know. Well, that's probably not an interesting thing for me to talk about right now, but I'll work it out when I get there.
Yeah, this is what I'm working with.
I think I'll just improvise. As soon as when I show up, I'll just.
And I think I will grab an actual shot glass to pour it because I can eye a fourth better. Anyone in chat have any advice for fighting Sword Saint Ishin in Sekiro? I'm stuck. Which one is he? Which one is Sword Saint? Trying to remember. The problem is they all run, all the names run together. He's not the guy up on the roof, is he? Because that's like, that was the crazy fight for me. That I had to like learn how to play Sekiro. Oh, the final boss. Well, it depends on what, the final boss. Well, isn't it, well, it depends on what phase you get on. The first phase is quite, can be pretty easy. Definitely, oh geez, there's so many, I don't even know what to tell you. You're jumping more, you're doing that jump move more when he pulls the spear out. Fuck. That's hard to say. There's four different forms of that boss. If you count the initial dude. It is such a long, crazy fight. I will say, you can do the final form, you have to do that lightning counter. You're stuck in second stage. Yeah, I think you're going to be jumping more. The spear is tough because it has a long reach. But essentially, you want to be using... Or the third, right? Yeah. You want to be using that jump move. Yo, what's up, Flum? Oh, from Dr. Daddy Bluetooth. Thank you so much. And I don't know what, man. That's just a tough fight, dude. There's just no way around it. This is a tough... You just have to learn his fucking movements. You just got to learn his bullshit.
You know what? A game I'm finding really, really satisfying, I played a little bit of...
Have a good one, K-Brown.
During this is actually playing for me being I maybe it's because I'm a New Yorker is playing Spider-Man.
Spider-Man's great.
It feels good. It's like be outside and it's like and go down there in the middle of Times Square and jump around. You have to worry about social distancing and high five some people. It's like and then go stop some burglaries and shit. It's a fun quarantine era game for me to be playing right now. Feeling like I'm swinging around New York.
Jeff, they took my favorite game of all time as a child, with its weird old 3D original PlayStation graphics, and they completely updated it to modern times, and they fleshed it out so much that they have to make it three different games.
Final Fantasy VII.
It is so fucking well done. I'm shocked at how much I'm in love with this game. The fighting is fantastic. Ring Fit is great, and I've been doing tons of workouts on stream. I didn't stream today's workout because I knew I was doing this stream. By the way, I officially did a stream every single day last week, which is crazy. I did a stream every day. I did the Week in Review with Carly on Monday night. Tuesday was the marriage test. Wednesday I did Ring Fit. Thursday I did Ring Fit. Friday I did Jackanese. Saturday I did Carly's Starfinder stream. And yesterday I did a Ring Fit stream. And today I'm doing fucking this. And I'm going to do a stream tomorrow. And I might do Ring Fit Wednesday and Thursday again. And so we may end up going all the way until Saturday before I take a day off from streaming. Yo, also, yeah, the combat is incredible, dude. The combat is incredible. But
in a second, Lindsay's going to take over for me first because I'm going to go kiss the girls goodnight.
Please. I welcome Lindsay in the chat. Man, so, baby, Alchemy, yeah. Steve, thank you so much for the sub. Bring her on. And then when you get back, you're going to do the karaoke song. And then
and then
we're going to do the thing.
Yeah.
All right.
Anybody wants to add some more karaoke songs so we can delay this a little
sure.
bit?
Sure. Oh, it won't delay. We'll do them after. We'll do them as soon as we're done. Here are the incentives, ladies and gentlemen. $5 for a toast or a roast to you from Jeff and I. $10 for choose one of us to perform karaoke. And $25 for lip sync competition. At the end of your stream string, I think you should finish it off with like the 12-hour-long fundraiser. Honestly, that's not a bad idea. I don't know if I'll do that next week. I want to plan that soon. I want to plan it soon, but I'll probably still put it off for a couple weeks so that I can really prepare for it and get good guests and everything. Jeff, what are you doing here still?
Well, she's doing something
I know,
right
I'm
now.
Just giving shit.
Alchemy Steve said loves Wizard and Bruiser.
Thank you so much.
No, guys. Jake actually came on one of these cocktails a couple months back.
We should bring him on for another one soon.
We did. I'd love to have him on. Yeah. That'd be great. We, oops, I just X'd somebody out for some reason. We did a Wizard and Bruiser cocktail, and I remember those are both really good, actually. But, yeah, I'd love to have Jake back on again at some point.
At the end of your stream string, I don't know. I'm losing my mind, dude.
You think you are now? Have your suicide shot, then.
Dude, this is gonna be so rough, bro.
Hey, Lindsay.
Losing it over there. Yeah, totally. We stand and prepared, Holden. Thank you so much. But yeah, I definitely want to do a 12-hour stream and raise up money for COVID relief. And I'll do a bunch of Ring Fit on it, and I'll have guests. And there she is.
Oh, hi.
Welcome, Lindsay, Jeff's wife. Hi. How's it going? Dealing with the kids while Jeff sits over here and his fucking stupid ass and drinks.
Oh, you know, it's fine. It's, you know, a woman's work. So
woman's work, of course. Absolutely, Lindsay. Of course, we all know Lindsay, classic nuclear family, homemaking, non-feminist. absolutely. Miss
yeah,
Reagan over there.
How are you doing, Holden?
I'm good. Oh, hell yeah, Alchemy Steve. We should get some games in on SF5 sometime. I'm good. We've got a bunch of high Lindsays in chat. I'm just worried about this suicide shot. I mean, what do you think here?
Oh, God.
So you want to know what I'm doing? Gin, vodka, and bourbon. Lillet, grenadine... cherry hearing liqueur, blank vermouth, and the blue passion fruit liqueur.
Oh, God.
Tomato juice.
Oh, God.
And topping it off with some Angostura bitters, I think, is what we're going to do.
Wow. That is just, that's going to, that will literally kill you.
Yeah, it's going to be rough. A quarter shot of each of these items, mix them all together.
That is pretty gross. Did Jeff go to get his stuff? Is that why I'm taking over here?
I think he's going to say good night to your children.
Oh, well, that's better.
But maybe, no, I think he's going to take
the
camera.
Also a good idea.
I think he's going to take the camera to the liquor cabinet and put the gun down on, please. I know, right?
It's going to be, that's going to be so.
My curiosity is if I put a quarter shot of each, how much is that in the end? Because I have to drink all
shots.
Of it. If it's quarter shots, hopefully it's like three quarters of the glass, maybe.
I mean, yeah, it's two. If it's a quarter shot each, that wouldn't that be 2.5 shots? Isn't that 10 things?
Yes, I should have just thought of that. It's 2.5 shots. Yeah. Okay, so that'll be like half a glass.
Yeah, gross. Got it.
I'd be died. Yo, what's up, Charlie Melancholy? Good to see you. And Ernie Permer.
I think you take a big swig of that, and I think you're gonna be.
I'm gonna try to slam it down. Oh. Yeah.
Oh,
I'm trying to drink it as fast as humanly possible.
That is okay. Yeah.
And then we have to run a lap around the block. Is the other thing.
Oh, good. I don't know which one is less safe.
Yeah. Will Chad? Do you think we will throw up doing this? Is the question. Tomato juice is really gonna fuck with me.
We taking bets because the tomato juice along with that blue whatever. What is that? What did you say?
The blue passion fruit. I love this stuff. This stuff is so good. The alizé.
Oh, sure. Yeah, you mix it with tomato juice.
Juice, though, it's not going to be that good. But hopefully the tomato juice will counteract the vodka a little bit.
Oh, sure. Yeah, but that's like you're doing the blue martini along with like a, I don't know.
Right. Well, you know, I think, Chad, there's a world where I could make it taste okay. But what's the fun in that? I promised that if I did it, I would pour some tomato juice in it.
Yeah.
So, it is what it is.
That's the sticking part there.
Right. I'll just slam it. I'm just going to drink it really fast.
I'm excited to smell whatever it is that Jeff makes when you guys do this. When are you doing this?
Like, right after he gets back. He's going to do a karaoke song. And actually, we should save the karaoke song for after we make it, huh? We should save the karaoke song for after we make the drink.
I love it.
Because then he has to, making him sing a song right after is pretty money. So we'll slam the drink, and then he will launch into the karaoke song. I think that's the best way to do it.
Amazing.
I don't even know what song it is. This is from Swishpod saying, here's an 80s jam for either one of you to sing. So I have no idea who it is.
Oh, it's just like a link that you click or something?
Got my first ever Rock Mount shirt in the mail today. I'm hyped as fuck. That's awesome. What'd you ask, Lindsay?
What, it's just like a link that you click? You don't even know what song it is?
No, because they sent me the link and the donation.
Cool.
Yeah.
That'll be exciting.
Yeah. Swishpod says, please do. It's appropriate. Perfect. All right, great. So that's what we'll do. So once Jeff gets back, we'll mix them together. We'll slam them. Watermelon White Claw's fire. I got to get into that. My problem is I want Watermelon White Claw, but they mixed in multi-pack for the watermelon is with mango, and I can't stand mango White Claw. It tastes like butter soda, and it's just, and that's not good. That's in a bad way. Yeah, it's gross.
I don't even know that I've had the watermelon, but I like White Claw, and I like fake watermelon taste. flavoring.
No, I know.
I dig that. That's my favorite.
It's funny because sometimes
fruit flavoring.
It's funny how sometimes you like things. The synthetic version of the taste better than the actual fruit it's based on.
Yeah, I do. Jeff and I are opposite there because I don't actually like watermelon that much, but the fake watermelon I'm into.
Where is Lexi tonight? She's in the other room kicking it. She's getting work done. She works better like in the evening, which makes me crazy because I have like a cutoff point of about 10 p.m. Bye, Lindsay. Thank you so much. Please continue to hang out with us too if you want. All right, Jeff, we've changed the order of things a little bit.
Gotcha.
Because it'll be more humorous for you to launch into the karaoke song after we are done with our drink. We're going to mix the drinks now. We're going to drink them. We're going to launch into, and then you're going to immediately do the karaoke song. All right, are you ready?
Yeah, I've got to gather my liquor.
Let me get my shot. Glass, rather.
And I'm gonna take the computer to the other room where I can.
All right, guys, it's time for the suicide shot. Here are all of the bottles. Again, I'm doing gin, bourbon, vodka, alizé. Blank vermouth, cherry hearing, liqueur, grenadine, Lillet, I don't know if I said that already. That one's back here.
Agnishura bitters, and tomato juice. All right. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna start mixing this. I'll tell you what. I'm gonna mix it in the shaker, and use ice in the shaker, but I will not. I will drain it of its ice. Would you do me a favor? Can you rinse these out?
Yeah.
Okay. So, where's my shaker?
I'm gonna go.
Why did my shaker disappear? Am I losing my mind?
I'm gonna go. Bourbon.
And
cognac.
Ooh.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Okay.
So let me do find.
Oh, it's staring me right in the face. I was like, where is my shaker? Where is my shaker? It's staring at me.
Use this. We use tablespoons. Oh,
all right. You both need Benny Hill music playing while I mix this.
What is cognac? Great question, T-Falls. What is cognac?
There's gonna be a follow-up question to this. It's sherry, I believe. Well, not sherry. I'm thinking the wrong word. What's the other thing? What would they drink in Downton Abbey? Not sherry, but cognac and
Al Capone blood.
Oh God. It's a kind. It's from the
brandy.
It's brandy. It's a kind of brandy, but it's from the cognac region, and so man, let's tilt this up a little bit.
Okay, I just did the gin and the bourbon. Why do I come up with these fun incentives? It's 7 o'clock. It sounds so good, and then you're actually doing it at 9, and you're like, what? Why am I doing this? Quarters? Yeah, it's a quarter. Oh, whoops, I keep pouring in the wrong thing. Okay.
This is gonna be appalling.
So,
yeah.
So gross.
I'm gonna stick with brown liquors.
Oh, shit.
So I got that going for me.
Cool.
Alright, I put the gin, the vodka, and the bourbon in. I'm gonna now do the Lillet.
I'm gonna do, I've got cognac. Bourbon and rye, and I'm gonna put some.
I keep over pouring, and I'm. It's gonna be so bad. I keep pouring too much in the shot glass, thus making my task even more difficult for myself. All right, now we're doing the blue Alize. Once again, there was a secret donation incentive of $100 for a suicide shot, which is 10 of the ingredients in front of us: 3 liquors, 5 liqueurs, and 2 wild cards. A bitter or something such. In my case, tomato juice and Agnishura bitters. In Jeff's case, bitters and absinthe. Here we have the Blanc
helping.
Vermouth.
She got me some. Oh, yeah. I'm gonna now add Cointreau.
Way over poured that. A quarter shot of each, by the way. All right, the cherry hearing. I think I still need to add the grenadine. It is a suicide shot. It was a $100 donation incentive. It is 10 of the ingredients.
What else? We
have
how many
here.
More do we need?
It is 3 liquors, 5 liqueurs, and in my case, Agnishura bitters and tomato juice.
Oh my God. Holden, was this from your wedding?
No, that's kind of the idea. But that's the whole point of the $100.
Holden, was this from your wedding?
No.
No.
It was from a wedding, and Lindsay was. We couldn't decide if it was from.
That is such a wedding thing, though.
It's limoncello.
Oh.
Well, we're gonna.
It's homemade limoncello from somebody's wedding.
That's nice. We just gave a stupid little star as a like a picture holder.
Wait,
the thing I'm most mad about is promising I'd put tomato juice in it.
Okay,
it's disgusting.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll put on some makeup and.
Okay. For the final hour, for the question cup.
Now I promised some,
Dude, I'm sweating already, dude. I'm so mortified right now.
Need to get back in there.
Maybe. It's very possible. I could, Lex asked if I was gonna vomit. I think people in chat might be taking bets right now. Okay. I have finished my mix.
This is absinthe that a friend of mine made. My friend Alec made. I'm gonna put a little bit of this in. Not much.
I'm gonna wait for you to pour mine out.
Take a bitters for me, would you, Lindsay?
I did.
Oh, I'm so curious.
Lindsay picked the Hellfire habanero shrub bitters for me.
Did I have to pee really bad? But I want to like do this. All right, I'm gonna pee first. Jeff and Lindsay, entertain them, please.
Oh, God. Lindsay, entertain them on TV.
Oh, okay.
Lindsay's gonna entertain you, everybody.
Hi, chat. Jeff is breaking things here, so that's fun. I know. He's definitely gonna swap it out of the bathroom, right? I mean, it would probably be better for him if he just like drinks the pee he's going to go and take. You're going to be on colostomy bags soon. LOL, have fun with that, Lexi. At least he didn't pee in the drink. I don't know, could have improved it. Habanero bitters, because MD Leo Spaceman, I think this is hilarious, and I want this to be as gross as possible, because I want it to be, like, worth the donation.
The square knot's fault, everybody.
Yeah, I blame the square knot for this. Oh, I can't, let me smell it. I'm very excited to smell this.
Okay.
That he has made. No, I think it's entrapment.
Okay. I'm gonna. Is Jeff ready?
Yeah.
All right, I'm pouring mine out. It looks like blood. It is a full glass.
Oh. Oh. Yeah, don't watch that either.
We're gonna. I'm gonna move back into the other room.
It looks just like blood.
Nah,
especially in the well, look in the
yeah.
Mine looks like Jesus. Mine looks like tobacco spit.
That's disgusting.
It doesn't smell that bad.
Not really, but
it doesn't.
This does. He said, that doesn't smell that bad. And I said,
oh, yeah,
this
that smells awful.
But also, you have like half a glass. I have a full glass because I fucking overpoured like all of my shots.
I was using tablespoons for mine. So.
Okay, I don't know if I'm going to be able to down this in one. Let's just, I'm going to take a big drink of it.
Yeah, we can't.
No, please don't shoot that. Neither of you. Like, okay. That's going to be. Blah.
Yeah, yeah, let's just kind of. I mean, all right, both, cheers, though. Jeff.
Do it.
Cheers.
It's not bad.
You no, said that bad. Like David.
David?
It's...
Lindsay!
It should be way worse than that.
It should be what...
Should I try it?
Okay. Yeah.
You taste like a fireball.
That second sip was a little different.
It
Are you
like
really going to try this?
No, I'm just going to smell it.
It tastes like fireball whiskey.
Yeah, it's...
Yeah, Lindsay's face.
It's got an after.
Like
it's got
it.
An
no,
afterburn.
It's not good, but
no,
it's not what I thought it was going
but
to be.
But it's.
The square knot you cited. You cited Space Captain on your paper. That's very
yeah.
cool.
Yeah. Isn't that neat?
Right here, copy and paste the MLA format for our movie that went into your work.
Why don't you
cited
switch with me? Because I feel like you're better now.
Jeff, I'm gonna put the link in chat for the song, so you can go ahead and cue that up while you finish your drink.
Oh wait, do I know the? Oh, are you?
We don't know. Nobody knows what the song is.
We don't know. We just know from Swish Pod. Here's an '80s jam for either one of you to sing, but I elected you because it's an '80s jam.
Yeah, this is Jeff. Jeff's the '80s guy.
Wait, that's
not it.
Let's watch Space Captain. Wait,
have you guys seen Sing Street? Have I bugged you about this already?
One of my good friends is in Sing Street.
Oh, really?
You should.
Sorry, we couldn't hear you. What? Yeah, one of my, well, he's not, he's the understudy for the main character.
Well, we had tickets for it before Broadway went dark.
Last Tuesday.
Yeah. But the movie is awesome, and it's about a kid in London getting, like, a new wave band together to impress in Ireland. to impress. He like looked like your old picture from like high school, Jeff, and it was to impress like this model, this aspiring model girl that he meets, and it's like such an amazing musical movie. It's like one of my favorite musicals ever.
It's so new wave. It's yeah, so, like...
I really wanted to see it. I was supposed to see it the night that he was actually taking over the role for the night, and then I didn't get to do it.
The riddle of the model.
The the main character, I think he's Rickon from Game of Thrones.
Oh!
Wow, that was a noise.
I think that's him. He's very familiar looking.
Where are we at, Jeff? Lindsay's getting in on the action. Do you want to sip of this?
Hi, Candy Ops. No, I don't want to sip of that.
I should know this better than I. Lindsay's gonna help me with this then.
All right, are you ready?
Yeah. Just like heaven.
There's more to it.
Yeah. Should we go for it?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
By the way, I finished my suicide drink. Thank you so much for the donation. I'm interested to see what effect it has on me in the future.
Yeah. I need a haircut so bad.
I'll cut your hair.
No. I'll cut my hair. It's okay. Thanks, babe. I love it without the music.
Oh, there it is. You're really good in this light, Lexi.
Again?
Oh, whatever. You're like Mariah Carey. Like, hot, young Mariah Carey.
That was too much personality.
Oh yeah, no silly grand lives for the cure.
Oh yeah. Yes, you're exactly right, zombie apocalypse.
You're all dressed up like the cure.
I love it when Jeff chair dances.
Beastars is nuts. Jeff used to dress like he was a member of the Cure. Yeah, I don't really play video games, I agree.
Oh, thanks.
Oh. I'm fine. No, I'm sober as I've ever been. I'm so sober.
Sweaty. You're like, you got moist.
Yeah, it's good to be moist. It might be just from mixing drinks.
Yay!
That was great. Thank you so much, guys. And Nightbot just posted the incentives again just in time. $5 for a toast to roast you, $10 to choose one of us to perform karaoke.
I remember cooking
and $25 for a lip sync competition with Jeff and I. Usually fun to close out the show. If you'd like to see more of that, we've got the question cup coming your way. But first, we should probably mix around of drinks. Lex, what would you do? You have a do you want a drink?
Sure.
What would you like?
I don't know. Surprise me.
Because tonight it's the dealer's choice.
And you're the dealer, so you get to surprise me.
It will be a bourbon drink. The available contents of your liquor cabinet. It's going to be blank parts of blank, blank parts of blank, add blank and or blank, shake slash stir with ice and pour, enjoy your blank. By the way, I made a really nice drink earlier that I made up. It was two parts gin. We need to get more of this. It's one part of this.
Should you want me to order some?
Maybe. One part of the Blanc vermouth.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's I added busy. Some and I added some orange bitters. Mwah. Two, really? Yeah, so 2-1-1 orange bitters. It was delicious.
Can I have that cut in half?
One half. That's like not much drink. You'll see. That's not.
Well, I don't want.
Like it's that. Physically not that much drink.
Okay, then just make it normal, and I'll
can
cut
you,
it with soda.
Can you be my little bar back for me? Can you just rinse this out, put ice in it, bring it back to me, and I will make you that drink.
We can let.
Thank you. I was about to say, I was like, really? You're not going to do
it? We can let Lexi and Lindsay take over for a minute, though, too. Make her.
I mean, we always could. Well, why don't we, in the future, I would like for you guys to do an episode of Cocktails at some point.
I think that's been discussed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I will be here to produce, but I will stay out of the way.
I think that, yeah, I would love that. I demand a redo of the theme song.
Sure.
And I demand a new title card. I have a lot of demands.
That's gonna happen, yeah.
All you have to do is you two have to get together and record somehow the theme song over like Skype or something.
Yeah,
you do it.
I like it.
Hey, what would you like to drink?
I would like a Sherlock.
A full size.
Yes.
Yes. All right, I'm gonna make this lady a lovely drink. So
fantastic! I will probably have a. Bourbon drink after I make her the drink. Where are the cocks? You're looking at them. Chris and Vera, you're looking at them. Yeah, it'll be Ladies Night Edition is what we'll call it. It'll be great.
Yeah, I would love that.
Yeah.
How often have you asked Lexi to, quote, be your little bar back, Holden? Once, just now, but I might do it in the future because it felt fun and sexy a little bit. Have a good one, Twin Peaks. You're probably gone already, but take care. Kenichi Maji says, if you want a drink that'll really make you throw up, try a shot or two of Mirin, aka cooking sake. Interesting. I need to get on my sake game. I love sake, and I never get it. And my liquor store carries it, and I should... I
like cold sake.
I like warm sake, actually.
I don't know. I can't do it for some reason.
I like it hot. There's a dope... Some like it hot. There's a dope sake bar that has a giant just sake menu. In the Lower East Side, that you can't go to right now, so don't even try. But if you do go there when the government lets us again, you walk downstairs. There's like barely a sign. You walk downstairs in this tiny little spot.
I love this place. I've actually been there. I like this place a lot.
Isn't it awesome? And it's
It just looks like a straight like you, there's no sign, and it looks like just like wood paneling on the outside. You have to like almost find the door, right? That place.
Yeah. Can you grab me a different shot glass, actually? You know, I don't think you want that shot glass. I think you're, wooden paneling, 100%.
Yeah.
Putting cream on your back? Well, that's fun. You could do it for the camera. Yeah. People love to see a woman put cream on her own back.
No.
You
get the feeling that, like you're, like you feel like something just needs to be put back in place. That's been my low back all day. I'm like,
Yep, absolutely. Usually it's, like, right around my shoulder blades. It's the worst. Just a preview of the scintillating conversation we will have when we do take over.
Yep, it is definitely, if Lexi's doing it, it's going to be a lot of ailments chatter. It's a lot of ailment discussion. She's got them in spades. Finished, by the way, someone mentioned Beastars earlier. We finished Beastars last night, and what a damn show.
I remember that we finished it.
What a show. Beastars. Beastars is like Zootopia meets Riverdale. It is like a sexy humanoid animal anime show on Netflix that Lexi and I watched all of, and it will give you a furry fetish, and it is very good. It is
I
very
do
good.
Not have a furry fetish. though. You and Jackie are the ones that took the
There are
that
some
is.
Sexy animal people in that show, is all I'm saying. All right.
Oh, Beastars. Oh, I see how it's spelled. Thank you, yeah. Something, I guess.
Beastars. Yeah.
Gross.
Beastars. You said you only want half of that recipe, so
no, we'll
one.
We'll do the full thing. We'll do the full thing.
This is. Uh huh.
Did you guys watch the after the Tiger King special?
I forgot that it existed, and I'm gonna probably watch it tonight. Is it good?
I thought it was pretty good.
All right, I'm gonna watch it probably tonight.
There were a couple of things that were sort of like, whoa, I did not understand that to be the case when we were watching this. So, yeah,
there's. It seems definitely like they definitely, and I'm actually okay with this. She's a man, baby, with 10 from Darcy LeGray. Sing for me. P.S. Love you, and thank you so much. I will definitely sing for you, Darcy LeGray. Thank you for that donation. That is incredibly generous of you. And thank you, everyone who donated. But I feel like they definitely took tons of liberties on that show to create an interesting story to watch on Netflix. And I'm kind of okay with that. I just wish that maybe there was a disclaimer of like, hey, we like kind of flirted with this story a little bit and messed with it in a way. You know what I mean? I don't know. I know that's like not ever going to happen, but I kind of wish.
Like, you always kind of have to think about that, like going into any documentary though, like they're always telling some kind of narrative.
Yeah. I always have to remember like, and the best documentaries are the ones that either super have a narrative, like the Thin Blue Line, where they actually got a guy off of death row. Yeah. Or ones that are like super as far back as they can be in terms of having a narrative, and they're just put a camera on the thing and showed it. And I'm trying to think of an example of that, but it's kind of documentaries. There's a Tiger King like extra like post show episode thing that we have to watch that just came out. Can you grab me two rocks glasses?
Sure.
Post show was.
Oh, thank you.
Have you guys been talking about Tiger King?
Yeah, I was saying the post. The
oh, it was fun.
Thing,
yeah.
It was pretty good.
Yeah. Joel McHale.
Do you think that?
Yeah, Joel McHale. You know, live from his house.
It's
the first like kind of like content that I've seen that's like filmed during this.
That's fine.
So that's what I found like most interesting about it is like literally here's Joel McHale and he's like on a phone at his house like on a couch. And he's like talking about the coronavirus crisis and like interviewing people like from his home. So to me, that was kind of just an interesting part about it.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, this is what content looks like right now. This is what this is right now.
That's so crazy. That's true. That is what content looks like right now. So do you think Carol Baskin killed her husband?
Yeah, I don't think so.
Yes.
I think so.
100%.
There's not a doubt in my mind that she killed her husband.
He's the only person I know that doesn't think that she did.
I hope she fed him to the tigers, though. I mean there's a thing that he might be under that septic tank, but the thing is, no. Feed him to the tigers.
Yeah,
come
you
on.
Can feed him
it's
to
like,
the tigers. Come on.
If you're going
to
be a fucking villain, be a villain. Feed him to the fucking tigers.
Yeah.
Right.
MD Leo Spaceman, they actually do talk about that a little bit, and they talk about that horse story. It's really interesting because even people who in the documentary seem like they're a little more pro Joe Exotic, they all to a one are like, no, he's an asshole. Like, you kind of get the sense that they feel like the documentary was very kind.
Oh, Lex.
Which is interesting. I didn't think that you were gonna reach over me. Sorry, I was picking up the drink while Holden reached out.
I'll look at it later. That's okay. We don't have to see.
What's
Shit.
Up?
I think Lexi just ruined cocktails somehow.
No, it's okay.
Sorry,
Lexi. It's not even that big of a deal.
It's all over me.
Oh my god, well, unfortunately, we're out and about and not anywhere near a change of pants or towels or
MD Leo Spaceman, I'm going to look that up. I'll be interested in reading that too.
I don't think so, yeah. I'm team. It's
copying the.
Oh yeah, we can.
Did you guys see the casting?
Drunk.
No, this new mouse. I have a new mouse, everybody.
That's
nice.
Exciting.
Yeah.
How are the girls? Are they still learning?
that's up to us, so it's it is what it is.
No, the answer is no.
No, actually, I have to say, you know, I have to spend a lot of the morning, which is sort of like prime learning time.
Right.
I have to spend a lot of that time doing my job, like posting stuff on my Google Classroom and interacting with my students.
Right.
And I have to take attendance now. The whole thing is crazy.
Weird.
But so Jess has taken over a lot of the school duties. So, and he's doing a good job.
He's teaching them about video games.
Very little
and
hitting.
Spider-Man.
Very little punching and hitting.
Yeah, I would say more kicking than anything, but even that is too. It's a pretty good minimum.
And they get it's like, oh, you know what happens now? You answered that wrong. You tried addition, we said subtraction. You get the belly. And I reveal my naked belly, mm-hmm. and I smack them as hard as I can with my naked belly.
That's great. That's great. That's good school.
All right, before we get into...
I'm going to mix this with a soda.
Okay, before we get into...
It's very good.
It's very good.
It's strong.
It's so good, you have to
really
put stuff in it.
No, it's strong. You know how I have to do
it. Before we get into Darcy's song, let's do some questions. I have the question cup right here, and here we... What?
Koala's
hey, Koala.
What's up, Koala?
Yo, what's up, Koala? Came in there, naked belly came in the right time. What would the name of your debut album be? What would the name of your debut album be?
Sweater Weather.
Sweater Weather, very good.
Wow.
Very good.
Lame.
By Jay Diggity, my rap name.
Mine would be daughter. Murder a Police Officer. No, that wouldn't be it. I would do Steal Someone Else's Album is what the name of mine would be. Steal Someone Else's Album.
I think mine would be Diet Starts Tomorrow.
Diet Starts Tomorrow.
That's also going on my tombstone.
Greatest Shits, that's good. Mine will be... Mine'll be I shit in the tub. I shit in the tub.
Don't say that.
Lindsay, what do you got for us?
Time to lie down.
Time to lie down. That's good. It'll be like Kings of Convenience. It'll be like Sweater Weather. It'll also be like Kings of Convenience. Very relaxing.
Or it'll be like lo-fi.
Yeah. Entrapments would be Rocket Science, of course, as he is a rocket scientist. Cobby Squared says greatest shits. I love it. Holy shit, I thought it was the only one who fucking hated Cops. Nice. Mom's favorite disappointment, says Ibulia Spaceman. I love it. Fantastic.
I can't believe Square Knot has not chimed in on this yet.
Maybe he's just blown away that we powered through that suicide shot so well.
I'm expecting some sort of poop-related album title for you, Square Knot.
We crushed through it. Square Knot, you better give us an album title. Your what would your debut album be called? Shoe paste. Mine would be Alexis or Divorso would be a good one. If it was
really
if
good.
It's you and I, it would be
somebody
Divorso.
Said shit, and somebody said, and then he said Alexis, and yeah, we've all watched the finale of Schitt's Creek, yeah?
No. We are on season five.
We just started season five.
We just started season five. We are almost there. We have been we have been blasting through that show faster than many.
I will give you no spoilers other than to say that it's beautiful.
Yep.
Great. It's good. It's yeah, great. We'll probably cry, I bet, which would be great.
Yeah,
you will.
I need a shower.
It's so binge-worthy. It is. It's actually our bedtime. It's like our, it's our bliss time before we go to bed activity. Like, it just,
that,
but we did just see the Crowening
that
episode.
Is our...
Oh my God, it's so amazing.
So funny.
Oh.
God, she's by far my favorite part of the show. She is just so amazing.
So good.
She's so incredible.
I've always known she's funny, but this is like above and beyond anything she's ever done.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's just...
This goes back, she's so funny in this, it goes back in time and makes everything she's ever done even more funny.
She's a man, baby. We've got a lip sync competition. Diana Ross, Holden, and Lionel Richie, Jeff, doing Endless Love. Thank you so much, Zombie Apocalypse. Greatly appreciate it. I gotta say something different than greatly appreciate it. I say that too much, and I feel like it's starting to sound disingenuous. Me thank you, me like you.
I like that. Do that for
Real quick, let me do this karaoke song for Darcy, and then we'll do some more questions from the question cup. Maybe you can help me with this karaoke, Alexis, my wife. Alexis, my wife. You're my everything. You're my necessary. You're my important.
Necessary.
Your best friend? Is she your best friend?
No, she's not. She's my lover, and there's a difference.
Hey, guys, I'm gonna say goodnight, actually.
Go for it.
I've been fighting a sinus headache for 3 days.
And the worst.
I don't have the COVIDs. I have a sinus headache. I'm fine. But that said, it is pounding right now. So I'm going to
go for it.
Yeah, I'm going to go.
Thank you for spending any amount of time with us with a headache and shit. Take care. Enjoy your lay down. Bye. Absolutely. Everyone say bye, Lindsay.
Good night, chat.
Everyone say bye, Lindsay.
I don't like
Goo Goo Dolls Iris. We're singing Goo Goo Dolls Iris.
All right.
How does this one go?
Yeah. Where's she going? Are you just seeing up there?
Oh, yeah.
And I'd give up forever to touch you.
Oh, 'cause I know that you feel me somehow.
You're the closest to heaven that I'll ever be, and I don't want to go home right now.
Yeah, Lexi,
all I can taste is this moment, and all I can breathe is your life. When sooner or later it's over, and I just don't want to miss you tonight, and I don't want the world. Be broken.
Take it, Lexi.
I just want you to know. I know. It's in a different key. I'm all confused.
Just follow through. Just love yourself for once in your life, for a millisecond of your life. Darcy Lee Gray, thank you so much. I'm so glad you like this song.
You can't fight the tears that ain't coming, or the moment of truth in your lies.
Sing along with us.
When everything feels like the movies, yeah, you bleed just to know you're alive. And I don't want the world to see me, 'cause I don't think that they'd understand. When everything's meant to be broken, I just want you to know who I am.
Devil horns. That's why I wore my evil red shirt. That's why he wore his devil costume. Darcy Lee Gray, I may or may not have this song tattooed to my body. Fantastic. It's kind of great, though. Just a little refrain. Okay, here's Wonderwall.
Wonderwall.
This is one of the songs that I'll hear, and I just kind of bop my head to. By the end of it, I'm completely belting out the song as loud as I can. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely, kamikaze.
I met,
And I don't want the world to see me.
Sorry, Jeff, it waits for no one. Because I don't think that they'd understand.
Everything's meant to be. Broken, I just want you to know who I am. I just want you to know who I am. I just want you to know who I am. Shoe pace, I'm gonna find you, gonna kill you, gonna take all your money, gonna take your baby, give it over to my wife, Lexi.
He's going to really do it. So don't.
I'm going to do it. Thank you so much, Darcy. Greatly appreciate it.
Interesting.
Damn it, I said greatly
appreciate it. Goo Goo Dolls.
Goo Goo Dolls. That was fantastic.
Yeah. I ran into them in a bar once. We and my friend Jeff Woods put one of their songs on a jukebox. This is probably back in the late 2000s, probably like early 2000s. And and he put it on, and like it immediately came up, and they were sort of like laughing off, like, "Oh, thanks," you know. And yeah, and he was like, "Oh, shit, I did not know you guys were here." So yeah, the Goo Goo Dolls were just drinking in the bar that we were drinking with, and yeah, we chatted with them a little bit. And they were like actually really, really, really cool. So
oh, that's nice.
I feel bad when we are compelled to make fun of the Goo Goo Dolls, because I know they are actually they
really nice people.
Shoepace is arming his house Home Alone style. I'm ready. Come at me, bro. Fantastic. I'm glad you're prepared now. I want to fight. I want it to be difficult. Darcy the Gray, that just made me realize just now how fucking banger of a karaoke song that is. I gotta pull that out of my arsenal, or add it to my arsenal.
Put it up your arsenal.
Put it up my arsenal.
Yeah.
Over and over again until I come harder than I would normally just with masturbation.
Okay.
Good. All right, let's do another question from the question cup. Jeff, you ready in chat? Please feel free to answer along with us. By the way, we will end the show with that dance-off donation, if you're curious. Oh, you'll like this one, Lexi.
Good fun, okay.
If you could own a mythical creature, a unicorn, a phoenix, etc., which one would you pick?
My favorite.
Which one?
Can you guess?
No.
Really?
So, you're mean, so it'd be like a mean monster. A minotaur.
Phoenix.
A phoenix, yes, of course.
I love
the Phoenix Saga and X-Men. You like,
That's not why, but
you like that. You like that.
I do. But, yeah, that's like one of my favorite superhero villains. But, no, Phoenix, I love them.
See, the problem with Mermaid is the problem I have
with... You have to keep her in the bathtub.
I was going to say Minotaur, and it would be like a protector for me. But the more human the creature is, the weirder I feel about owning it.
How about a chupacabra? How would that be?
Chupacabra is a cool one. So Shoepace, you fall in that same category. Chupacabra is a good one. Phoenix is a good one. I'm going to go with...
I mean, we love birds.
I'm going to go with the Minotaur to guard the front gate of my mansion.
What mansion?
Like, in this mystical scenario.
Oh, okay. All right.
I might have a mansion someday. Why? I wish you're my wife. I wish you would like have my back or sort of whatever.
What about you, Jeff?
Jeff already said.
What did he say?
Slender Man.
I'm
gonna be terrified always.
just to discipline your girls.
Yeah, I want them to wake up with a faceless man in a suit.
I'll open the Slender Man closet if you don't eat your peas. No.
I'd probably go with like a gnome.
Right.
I think it'd be kind of funny. Right. I'd like to see a gnome play with my cat.
I'll just admit it to wanting to. I'm saying I don't want to. I feel like the more human the creature is, the more problematic it becomes.
A griffin would be cool too.
Yeah, whatever.
But griffins in Witcher will fucking like tear you apart slowly.
Yeah.
Yeah, see, I love phoenixes. That's just
a griffin
in
Harry Potter might be one thing, but a griffin in Witcher? Fuck you.
Did I say centaur? I meant minotaur. Minotaur. Did I say centaur?
No, you said minotaur. And a centaur would be very useful because they could engage in conversation and you could ride them.
See, a minotaur, I'd want to be my lover.
You're just a roommate who's like fucking, who's going to destroy your floors.
That's true. You could only live on the first floor.
Yeah.
This might be more of a question for chat to answer about us, almost, than for us to answer, but I would also be interested in your answer.
Mm-hmm.
Who would play you in the movie of your life?
Chat, go.
Who would play us in the movie of our life? If I were to guess for you, Paul Giamatti, maybe?
Mm.
For Jeff?
I don't know why I always get that.
That's not the first time for you. Who has breasts the size of the world?
I've got Paul Giamatti. I'm a hybrid of Paul Giamatti and Mark Ruffalo. Weirdly, I
could see the Mark Ruffalo.
The Joel. We will definitely be playing Dark Souls and Final Fantasy VII Remake on Marriage Test tomorrow night at 9 p.m.
Copy Squared. Or us.
Copy Squared. Who's playing Skeet Ulrich? Because all of us want to be...
I'd like to think Skeet Ulrich playing literally all of us.
All of us.
Charlize Theron for Lexi.
Oh, that's very nice.
That is nice. That's good, though. That's
very
a good
nice,
one.
But I'm
no, who's the one that you get all the time? Jane Krasinski, right? Or
Jane Krasinski.
Who's the, wait, which one's the annoying one that's always like, ah, she's always like complaining? Which one's that
Jane
one?
Krakowski.
Jane Krakowski, perfect. Yeah, actually, Jane Krakowski would be great. I was joking, though. I was joking.
Yeah.
Oh, it was playing you, Cobby Squared. Gotcha. I was asking for us. Natalie Dormier for Lexi.
I get that. I got that before.
That's good, because I like her.
I don't remember who. I haven't seen you up until this moment. I just want to say hello, Jen. I hope you're doing well.
Hell yeah. Yeah, Natalie Dormier for Lexi. Awesome.
Cool, I'm into it. That's great. Thanks.
Mary Elizabeth Winstead says the apple cart.
Ooh, I love her.
I also appreciate Jaw, thank you. I get this a lot. Dwayne The Rock Johnson for me. That makes a lot of sense. I was thinking Alison Brie, actually, for Lexi a little bit. A little
that
bit.
That makes sense, too.
That makes sense. Because she sort of has that, she's beautiful, but she has that self-deprecating energy as well.
Thank you.
Henry Zabrowski is Holden. Jeff is Mark Ruffalo is Jeff. That's a good one. Me is myself, because I'm a really good actor. Hey, baby, I heard you haven't been around here lately. Me cook, me cook.
Sleeping on the couch.
Weird. My boyfriend tells me
Mark,
I look like
Mark
Natalie Dormer all the time.
Mark
awesome.
Me with fucking Ben Shapiro dubbing his voice. You need like a nasal, whiny, annoying voice to get me.
You're not nasal and whiny.
I was listening to that. I watched a little bit of like the YouTube stream of like the last one when we did these, and I was like, oh my God, that's my fucking voice. That's my voice.
You're fine.
Pauly Shore is Holden. I'm insulted by that. Matthew Broderick as Jeff is really
that
good.
Works.
Tom Green also, I think, works.
Or for
me.
You. Or
Keira Knightley for Lexi.
That's nice. Roland Shit. What, Chris Elliott?
Chris Elliott. Oh, that is so insulting.
Oh no, God, I don't mean it as an insult. I'm sorry.
Just like current looks, Holden could be Billy Eichner. I could see that, but I don't know if he could handle it. Yeah. Mm. Henry Cavill put on some lumpy prosthetics and a beard and glasses he could be Holden. Yo, what's up, Stealing Valerie? Good to see you in chat. All right, we're changing it up. What's the next question from the question cup? Again, question cup. Here on Cocktails, I pull out the questions. We answer them all together, chat, and the hosts. What's your favorite smell?
Jasmine.
What's your favorite smell? You know it fast.
Jasmine.
Love campfire smell. Love a woody smell.
I like that
too. For sure.
You actually took mine. I was going to say probably the smell of like a campfire.
Maybe a despair, says Gabby Squared.
So
campfire, right, has a certain great smell. That's not my only favorite smell, but I love a woodsy smell for sure. I mean, weed,
burning
obviously.
Wood smells good.
I really legitimately like the smell of really fragrant.
Fresh baked bread.
Ooh.
Yeah, that's actually.
Oh, yeah, dude. Burning wood. Yeah, a lot of people are saying wood burning for sure. It's so comforting, too. It's like, it means so many things. Not only does it smell pleasant, but it also just screams comfort.
Mm-hmm. I like bergamot, too, and lavender. We have bergamot bitters.
Ooh! What? Where are they?
They're in the little bitters packet.
I might add them to my...
Make them in your the next old fashioned.
I'm gonna put them in my drink I'm drinking right now, actually.
Why not?
So we've got...
Cherry tobacco
cardamom.
Says... Charmingly Melancholic says cherry tobacco. Swish Pod says Gwyneth Paltrow's vagina.
Okay, I can see that.
I guess
I
that
see.
Goop.
Which one? Unbelievable.
Well, Cobby Squared said, as an ex-baker, Jeff, you were spot the spot the fuck on.
Yeah, that fresh baked bread is like the great, or like
lavender, not bergamot. I'm sorry.
Or like the fresh baked cookie smell. Mm. Like add a little chocolate into that sugary dough. My family home is heated with a wood burner stove, so I love wood smoke. Hell yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Goop, fantastic. Gwyneth Paltrow's vagina. Yeah. Rory Scovel as Holden. Okay.
Mm. Somebody said a new, who was it? Said a new comic book smells awesome.
Evan, it's so good to see you.
The Jaw 13, a new comic smells.
Jackie Z's neck, absolutely. It does always smell quite fragrant, for sure. So good to see you, Evan. Chanel number 5, mainly because it reminds me of my grandmother. Yeah, a lot of people have those associative.
Yeah, my grandmother wears Cartier. Always.
The jaw. I love new book smell. So good.
There was a car. Is it still a thing, the car smell, new car smell? Is that still a
sure,
thing?
Sure, I love new car smell. Like, yeah, new thing smell. Because that was the,
My grandparents' car, I remember growing up, like, always smelled like that. I don't know how they maintained it, but their car, it was an old, it was like a station wagon. It was this big old brown, like, station wagon. It wasn't a station wagon. What was it?
But it always smelled.
It doesn't matter. The car doesn't matter. The smell of the car. It was a Thunderbird. That's what it was. It was an old Thunderbird.
I just love it with Jeff, because the drunker he gets, the more lost in the details he gets when he tells the story. It's like, I think it was a red shoe with a
somebody's going to have a reference. They're going to think, oh, it was a Thunderbird. And like, it's going to take that.
Your mother says it was definitely a Thunderbird.
And they're going to come back and they're going to bring 5 friends next time.
Your mother definitely says it was a Thunderbird, by the way.
It was a Thunderbird. Yeah, my mom. Yes, yeah. Thunderbird always smelled like a new car, Mom, right? So.
Oh, mountain air. Just waking up in the morning in the mountains and walking outside, that smell.
I can't.
Oh, smell.
I can't, like.
Smells like wind.
Close my eyes and smell it.
Top 3 things on your bucket list. Top 3 things. How about, I'll tell you what, just 3 things on your bucket list. It doesn't have to be the number, the top 3. 3 things on your bucket list. Beach smell is also fantastic. 3 things on your bucket list. I will name 1 now. We'll go around.
Okay.
All right. Fuck, what's mine? Run a marathon. I still would like to. I ran a half of 1.
No, that's great. I would like to.
They're
going to
cancel the Brooklyn half this year, too.
So. I bet. Find my virginity, says Nader 420. Find it. Lost it. Got to get it back.
I don't know. I think I did win an Oscar.
Okay, win an Oscar for Lexi. What do you got, Jeff?
I don't know.
They could be fun, dumb ones. It could literally be like, you know, skydive.
I do want to go skydive.
Yeah, that's like a bucket list.
Yeah, like learn how, like, animate something.
Mm.
I'd love to animate. So even just like one cartoon.
That's a good one.
One little 5-minute long cartoon. Excuse me. I'd love to do that. So.
Work on a writing staff of a TV show.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That'd be cool.
That would be awesome.
That'd be really cool.
I would love it to work with you on a project for something.
Ooh, okay. Well, yes, I do know that. But I guess you mean outside of, like, we already do the marriage test stuff, outside of streaming.
I mean, like
Twitcherman. I mean, we write, produce, and act in a monthly or bi-monthly sketch comedy show, semi-monthly sketch comedy show. We do a live stream once a week.
I mean,
we definitely,
like,
do shit together.
I mean, like, a script.
Right, on, like, a scripted
book.
Piece of something. Or a book. Okay,
or
interesting.
Or a book, yeah.
You want to co-write something with me?
We were talking about that last night.
Maybe.
Remember?
Yes, I do. What was the idea again?
Don't worry about it.
What was the idea again?
I also want to write my memoir.
Yeah, but now I want to know what the idea was.
Mm-mm. I don't want to talk about it on stream.
Why?
Just move on.
Give me a keyword.
No, move on. Move
Why?
On.
Why would you do that? Why would you let me do that?
Just move on.
Why? Because text me. Can you text me it?
Yeah.
Okay, text me.
It's too
me
personal. Talk about it on stream. Jesus.
Okay, well, then we'll never do it. Well, then we'll never put it out because it's too
Hold
personal.
On, just move on.
Well, we'll never do it. I'm telling
it's
you right now.
Talking about what we were talking about last night.
Right.
It's not necessarily the thing that I want to do.
Okay.
This is one of those moments where I feel like I shouldn't be here.
If it's personal, you're never going to get it written and put out. Jeff,
like,
what do you got?
My next thing, know what love feels like. I'm sorry. I was testing to see if she was listening. She went, "What the fuck?" to the other room. So, no. The next thing for me is actually try to get one or more of my plays published. I've got some plays actually. Kentucky Goblin Stage is the first one that comes to mind. Actually, Lexi, that's the one. That's the show that we met Lexi on.
Yeah.
She auditioned for it.
In fact, I was looking at photos from that earlier.
And yeah, it was amazing. It's a It's a good, I think it's a solid show, and I've actually even improved a little bit since then, because now that I know what it's like to be a parent, because there's a father character in it, and it's like, so I can add a little bit of dimension to that. Yeah, I feel like that should be out there. It's been performed by us, by No Tea Productions, our theater company, but it's also been performed by two different high schools to like really, really great success.
That's
so
awesome. I feel like it is perfect for like high school kids too, I think.
All right, so. Northern Lights, Kamikaze Mixtape says, visit each continent and play a show out of country. Lots of traveling things. That's awesome. Zombie Apocalypse, Float in the Dead Sea. Comedy Square, wear a monocle unironically. That's so doable, yet so difficult. Drive a 700-plus horsepower car, says Entrapment, around a racetrack, or drive over 200 miles per hour. That's super cool and doable. Sleep with any member of the idol group AKB48. That is so unachievable. I hope it happens for you, though. Charm of the Melancholic, make art that doesn't suck. There you go.
Travel. You already do that.
Absolutely. By the way, it's already bucket list fulfilled. Travel to Ireland. Get scuba certified and work on a TV show. All great ones. I don't really play video games. Perform at Edinburgh Fringe or try every egg. There are different eggs. Oh, every like type of bird egg. Andy Leo, the week-long Lord of the Rings filming location and Weta workshop tour. Damn, that's a week long. That would be amazing. Do comedy full-time. God damn it, I didn't think... He remembers. I legitimately was trying so hard to remember what we talked about because I legitimately thought it was a good idea. So I literally just want to know what it is. So can you just text me so I know? Because it's one of those things where I have a control issue and I like lose my mind when someone's like, I'm not telling
you.
I'll never tell you. I'll never tell it to you. And I just like, just tell me because I'm going crazy in a control freak way.
I'll tell you later. Just don't worry.
Just text me right now.
Why does it have to be right now?
I just want to know. I'm dying to know. I'm dying to remember.
You just need to
We talked about it. I thought it was a good idea. I don't understand why you won't text me it right now. I'm not going to say it out loud. I just want to know. I'm dying to know. Comedy, yeah. Be in a horror movie, totally doable. Darcy, you should do it. Legalize love or just show me on the...
Shut up. Just focus on your stream.
You have kids, Jeff. Oh, that was back when you said something about love. Ascend with Bunny McLickens. I don't even know what that is. Get into a good relationship, get SRS, being a speech therapist. After this COVID shit, do an open mic. Yes, please. All that shut down now. Murder all of the Spice Girls using something in their surname. Interesting.
You said do an open mic.
Charm of the Melancholic, been working on it forever.
I'm not done. Can you just like,
Like, I want to encourage Charm of the Melancholic to do an open mic because I feel like you could be awesome with that. So I really, I want you to do that. Do it. Do it now. Not now, because it's COVID.
Eat 12 sticks of butter in one sitting, currently moving on to my fourth. That's fun. Thank you, Tom. Tom Thompson Hip Hop. Okay, it wasn't as hard to read as I thought it would be. Thank you. Greatly appreciate it. Yeah, that it's a lot. I really hope you're able to do that someday. That would be a trip of a lifetime. Kenji having sex with one of the women from the K or J-pop group? Take my son to Japan. I went a few years ago and it was fantastic. Hell yeah. I'd like to get enough people together to actually perform and film a sketch I wrote. Hell yeah. Did I do two? I think I did two at this point. Thank you.
I'm moving over here so I can be on the stream.
Oh, yeah. Okay, totally.
What, Jeff?
I'm moving over closer to this side of the screen so I can be closer to you guys.
Aww. You're so sweet.
Yo, what's up, Flom? Welcome back.
Jeff. Aww. Mwah. I miss you.
What else?
Drink has flowed tonight, has it not?
What?
Yes, it has. Absolutely.
You have 5 minutes. You better do that lip sync.
We will do the lip sync very soon. Let's do dark.
Nobody has anything else they're expecting of us at this point, do they? There's no more karaoke or anything.
Yes, we have a lip sync challenge.
Okay, cool. But I mean, nothing else aside from that.
Yeah, we're good. That's it to close out the show. Damn, time has flown.
Yeah, it has.
Time has flown. What best game in quarantine? I mean, Final Fantasy VII Remake's great. If you're talking about new releases. But honestly, if you were like not a big gamer, I think The Witcher 3 is the perfect quarantine game because it is an obscene amount of hours of gameplay and it is super fun and it'll just last you forever and you just get lost in that world. You know what I mean?
And I want to say, actually, Spider-Man is great too because you get to feel...
It's a good one.
Social. It's fun too because like even just like walking around the middle of Times Square in New York and like, you know, high-fiving people and stuff, you know, just those parts of the game where just
it's like I'm getting out, but I'm not.
Those sort of like non, you know, fighting parts of the game are really, really fun right now. I went back to that and I'm really enjoying that. So,
awesome Kamikaze Mixtape playing nothing but Dark Souls list of podcasts. All right, we're gonna go into this final lip sync, the final question of the night, by the way. What is your favorite position to sleep in? Mine is on my right side, except I think that depending on what side of the bed I am, I think I just need to be facing out.
Yeah, can't have your back to... Yeah, can't have your back to the bed. Because when the monster gets you, you're not going to be able to see him because he'll be behind you.
Yeah, I'm not really sure why. I'm just more comfortable facing away or towards. But in our situation, I sleep on the left side of the bed.
You sleep on the right side of the bed.
Okay, sure.
If you're laying in bed, you sleep on the right side.
On the right side. Right, I'm thinking of looking at the bed from the foot of the bed. I sleep on the left side of the bed and face outward.
I sleep on the right side, and so Holden and I face away from each other. And
you like sleeping on your back, though. You're kind of all over.
But I fall asleep on my left side with my head in my hands. I always do this, and then lately I've been folding a pillow and putting it between my knees, and that's been helping with my back a little bit. So.
Evan, Street Fighter Tiger knee style, dude, that is the greatest. Absolutely, I like the knee out as well. Jeff, what do you got?
I'm on the left side of the bed, and I sleep on my front just with my head twisted, and I need to switch back and forth throughout the entire night, really.
For your neck.
And, I love it. It's so interesting how different it is for everybody.
They say that there was like a personality evaluation thing that had to do with the way you slept, like what type of sleeper you are with like how you face the world. And how open to other people you are, if you feel dominant over people or if you feel like you are the more submissive one. And it's really interesting. And it's like Dr. Phil and Oprah. Like Dr. Phil brought it on an episode of Oprah and they each took the quiz. Anyway, it was cool. So I don't know. Look it up. It's kind of neat.
All right.
It makes sense to me.
So we're going to close out the stream with me as Diana Ross and Jeff as Lionel Richie performing Endless Love. Ladies and gentlemen, Endless Love. Lexi, please feel free to commentate.
Oh, yeah.
If you'd like, yeah. If you'd prefer. And
bye, Apple Cart.
Have a good one, Apple Cart. Take care. Would love to talk real soon. For real, for real. All right.
So who's who?
He's Lionel Richie.
There's only you in my life. The only thing that's right.
Mr. Sprawl giving it to us nice and real.
My first love. You're every breath that I take.
McNeely giving us the attitude with the neck. Bet you didn't know he was wearing a tie.
I want to share all my love with you.
There's so much love happening over these two Zoom windows right now.
And your eyes.
Mr. McNeely's lost two some weight.
Hearts. Two hearts that beat as one.
This is also our the slowest Holden can actually ever move. And for Jeff, this is just comfortable.
Forever. I'll hold you close in my arms. I can't resist your charm.
Mr. Sprawl, down in the mouth, doing the child nap, the baby nap. It's a new signature he's been working out.
For you,
if you're just joining us, this is Cocktails and the People Who Drink Them. Beautiful.
Shout outs to Alexis and, of course, Lindsay for joining Jeff and I in this special quarantine edition. I'm about to sneeze. Quarantine edition of the stream. Of course, that means tonight was the dealer's choice. Whatever's in your liquor cabinet, just
wait,
blank, course, blank.
Oh, God.
Blank, course, blank, blank, and blank. Whatever. Just stir it. It's just whatever you have at this point because it's just it's whatever we've got. Oh, whoops. That's, what is that? No. Those are the donations people gave tonight, so I'm glad that that was showcased, actually. Thank you so much for that.
Zombie apocalypse, I'll be happy to.
Lindsay, welcome back. We are closing out. Just this is the part where we say goodbye to everybody. Have a good one. Where are Bebe's quarters? The kids are on the other side of the living room.
Bebe.
Such a fun night. Absolutely. I had a great time. Lexi, fly to Houston and cut my hair, please.
Flights are like $1.50. So.
I know. We need to buy a bunch of plane tickets.
Yeah, we do. And we will.
Just to see what happens.
For sure. All right. Have a good one, everybody. This was such a fun one. I don't know how. Oh, we're going to be playing Jackbox over the South Side Boys Discord tonight. Go over
awesome.
There. Go do that.
What
were we going to say, Lindsay?
Nothing. I just said that sounds fun.
Oh, awesome. Cool. All right. Take care, everyone. I'm going to play the outro. And yeah. And we're going to call it a night.
Shall we raid?
I think I'm going to. I don't think we have people to do that. That's fine.
No, Southside Boys. Oh, that's Discord. Got it. Never mind. That's not a stream. Sorry.
No, it might be on their Discord. Yeah. So... you know what? I'm just going to play music and I don't have the,
What's going on?
I guess I accidentally got rid of the,
oh Holden broke.
I broke. I got rid of the outro, but I want to do it right, so I'm going to load it up right now.
Okay.
All right, cool. Everybody, say goodbye.
Bye.
Bye,
guys. Everybody.
And then, oh, is this going to be it right here? Perfect, sort of.
Virtual hug for all of you.
Bye, everyone.
There it is.
Uncomfortable.
There it sort of is. I'm fixing it. Whatever, it'll be like sort of it. Have a good night, everybody.
Cocktails,
woo!
With Jeff and Holden.
Cocktails,
woo!
With Jeff and Holden.
Cocktails,
woo!
With Jeff and Holden. Making cocktails for you. Making you laugh. Making you blue.
Cocktails. I can rate Alex Sucks.
Cocktails.
Is that square nine?
With Jeff and Holden. Cocktails.
Woo!
With Jeff and Holden. Holden. With Jeff and
Jeff.
And
Jeff.
All right. I'm rating Alex Sucks. Have a good night, everybody. See you later. I'm about to rate it. It's going to happen.
Rate it.
Rate it.
Three, two, one. Done.
Ow! Oh, so, everybody's gone.
When are we going to do the...